Let's face it, most people aren't making massive turkey feasts on the regular. And after 364 days of not thinking about it, it can be hard to get that bird just right. That's where Instacart, the holiday rescue app, comes in. From getting all the ingredients to prep a full seasonal spread to getting last-minute swaps in a turkey emergency, Instacart has everything a holiday host needs to save face and save dinner. And right now, if you download Instacart, you'll get free delivery on your first three orders and delivery in as fast as 1 hour. Offer valid for a limited time. $10 minimum per order. Additional terms apply.
Looking to give the gift of pleasure? Add a little high heat to keep the desire burning. Or maybe you just need a little self-care. Come to Lovers for the best lingerie and toys to keep things hot this holiday. Save 20% on your purchase with Lovers Afterglow Rewards. Just mention LOVE20 at one of our 18 Western Washington locations. Offer valid with free Lovers Afterglow Rewards membership until November 30th. Some exclusions apply.
Hey, it's Mike Hawk. Want more Men's Room content? Follow the Men's Room page of the Odyssey app and check out my live stream, A Moment with Mike Hawk and Nothing in Particular with Steve the Thrill Hill. Going live Thursdays and Fridays at 1, exclusively on the Men's Room page of the Odyssey app.
Unfortunately, what you're about to hear is real. The members of this radio program are simply not that bright, or what some people would call educated. They are merely stupid. They're not trying to offend anyone on purpose, and all have played doctors on TV. You have been warned and are cordially invited to join the party. This is the Men's Room.
Forget it, man, and get with the countdown. Get with the countdown. Shake this square world and blast off for Kicksville. The trippers, the grasshoppers, the hip ones, all gathered in secrecy and flying high as a kite.
This is the Men's Room with Miles and Thrill. You know what they say, shake your radio more than three times, and you're playing with it. You're listening to the Men's Room.
And away we go. Welcome to Season 18, Episode number 3,983. Along with Steve the Thrill Hill, the Ted Smith, and my car. Montgomery! And you, are in the Men's Room. On tap today, the return of Who Sucks Less. We will play Profile This. Plus headlines, the Men's Room Shout of the Day, fun with listener emails, and everyone's favorite,
TV Time with Ted.
Click, clap.
Drink until drunk. All right, here we go as we head to Dearborn, Michigan, where three different men have been caught spanking it in public three times this week. Meanwhile, a low-flying helicopter in Australia is making crocodiles do the freak. Florida man gets 30th felony after shooting down a police drone from the sky. Stealing from Hardee's customers to bail out inmates, that is not going to fly. And a cemetery worker, he falls into an open grave. Yeah. That is all coming on today's very special episode of The Men's Room.
And now, here's the question.
Hola, bitches. Good day to you and yours. All right, one of the many things that police officers are trained to do is the pit maneuver. Now, you know the pit maneuver. The cop targets the back of a vehicle, causing it to fishtail, spin 180 degrees, and stall. Well, the state trooper in Arkansas successfully pulled off a pit maneuver during a high-speed chase on I-40. Now, the only problem, he crashed his vehicle into the wrong car. Yeah, oops. But hey, people make mistakes. For example, everyone gets angry. And sometimes those angry people do things like throw things at the person they're mad at. Like the woman in Florida. She got into an argument at a restaurant. She threw a burrito at the guy and missed and hit an entirely different guy in the face. Again, with a burrito. Good times. Look, it'd always be worse. There's a roofing company in Florida. They took the roof off of the wrong house. And a demolition company in Texas, you guessed it, they tore down the wrong house. But like we said, people make mistakes. All of us do, and more often than we'd care to admit. That said, today we ask you to come clean and tell us about your personal faux pas, blunders, gaffes, and oopsie doodles. So today's question is this. Who screwed up? And how did they screw it up?
To be a part of the big show, call 206-803-ROCK. Like the Men's Room on Facebook, follow us on Twitter and Instagram at Men's Room Live, and send your emails to themensroom at KISW.com.
I'm Snoop Dogg, and I'm giving up smoke. I know what you're thinking. Snoop, smoke is kind of your whole thing, but I'm done with it. I'm done with the coughing and my clothes smelling all funky. I'm going smokeless. Solo stove, fixed fire. They took out the smoke. Now you can have a nice blaze without any clouds ruining your day. Go smokeless. Go to solostove.com. Tell them Big Snoop Dogg sent you.
Are you dealing with a personal injury? Don't go it alone. Turn to the experienced team at Phillips Law Firm. Their attorneys have helped thousands of clients get the compensation they deserve. Call Phillips Law Firm now. Call 1-800-JUSTICE or visit justiceforyou.com.
Getting older means a world of change, but some things still stay the same, like being at risk for type 1 diabetes, because type 1 can happen at any age. So screen it like you mean it. If just one person in your family has type 1, you're up to 15 times more likely to get it too. And 50% of type 1 diagnoses happen after the age of 18. So screen it like you mean it. Type 1 diabetes starts long before you need insulin, and one blood test could help you spot it early and lower the risk of serious complications like diabetic ketoacidosis, known as DKA. So don't get caught by surprise. Screen it like you mean it, because getting answers now can help you get prepared. The more you know, the more you can do. So don't wait. Talk to a doctor about how to get screened. Tap now or visit screenfortype1.com to learn more. Again, that's screenfortype1.com. And screen it like you mean it.
Transit is better with an Orca card. Here's why. One, it's easy. Just tap and pay your way onto Metro and all other public transit around the Sound. Two, your tap shows us when and where you're riding the most, so Metro can serve you better. And three, Orca cards are for everyone. 18 and younger now ride free with a free youth Orca card. So what are you waiting for? Get an Orca card, tap for transit, and make your ride count today. Visit kingcounty.gov/tap for transit.
9.9 KISW.
Obachals, away we go. Welcome to season 18, episode number 3,983. What a large and in charge program we have for you today. Guaranteed future repeat, the exciting return of Who Sucks Less. Steve, I don't know how you do it. You find people in the news doing bad things. You bring us three of those stories each and every week. It is up to us to determine out of the three stories which one sucks the least. Now, how are we doing this week?
It's not the worst, but we have a dog walker, we have a Burger King manager, and a stalker, but an unusual stalker.
Burger King manager changed the schedule, but didn't tell anybody, and I didn't show up, and he fired me.
He didn't tell anybody, or he didn't tell you?
Well, he I don't know, because I don't know how many other people were involved, but I know that I was. And I know that he was like, okay, you need to find out what the schedule is. I said, well, I wrote the schedule down. You changed it. He said, but you need to keep up to date. I was like, well, I wasn't here the last 2 days, so I didn't know.
That you changed the schedule.
That you changed the schedule, bro. So
how many years ago was that? Because the bitterness you have about this is still palpable.
I was 16 years old.
You're still
pissed. I was
16
years old, yeah. I was like, dude, I mean, like, you got to call me. I have a phone. You have my phone number. I actually live at a residence. I live at home with my mom.
Right.
There's a phone there that works. All you got to do, we have an answering machine. All you have to do is say,
oh, aren't you fancy?
I changed the schedule. Can you come in on Thursday and Friday, not just Friday? So I came in on Friday. He said, where were you yesterday? I said, I wasn't scheduled. He said, go home. And I'm like, what?
I don't think he liked you.
I don't think he did either, but I don't care. I still was just like,
I do like the bitterness, though.
Yeah.
I applied for a job, and it was between me and another guy. He basically said you had it, and he never called me back. It was at a driving range.
All right.
I was pissed for a couple months, but yeah. Hit plenty of golf balls there.
Right. But like, it's not on me, man. It's on you. So whatever. All right, Who Sucks Less is coming. What else do we have for you today? Oh, boy, more Men's Room every Monday through Friday, exclusively on Odyssey and the Odyssey app. Join us for the Men's Room Happy Hour in episode number 477 coming up. If you don't have the Odyssey app, download it now. It's absolutely free. There's all kinds of free content on there. Different podcasts. And Ted, you said you believe that the Tony Kornheiser podcast is on there.
We just played a commercial for it.
Okay, so it must be on there. I think Stephen A. Smith has got a podcast on there. All kinds of famous people. We are also on this app.
Mm-hmm.
So if you want to listen to our show, you know, anytime you can. If you miss an episode or you want to listen to one of the
brand new The Podcast, podcasts, brand new Megacast.
Out within the last 24 hours.
Yep.
Our Greatest Story Never Told podcast, 86 or so episodes there. We just ran out of things that we could actually tell you before being self-incriminating.
Yeah. I mean, there's a point where, like, and we seriously, we had to go to the bosses and say, we have to stop. Yeah. There's more stories, like, but there's yeah. just certain ones we can't tell.
Some got us in trouble, and we're like, man.
That's the thing. I remember getting pulled in the hair club's office, man, and I mean, door shut.
Oh, they're so mad.
Screaming at us. And it's like,
you asses.
You asked us to do this, man. Mm-hmm. Yeah. I'm sorry you didn't know that story.
Was that a post-show one?
No. That was not one of those.
No.
Got in trouble for those, too. This was, you know, we recorded it, and yeah, the boss heard it. You said, like, the greatest story never told. You didn't know that. You don't like the story. Now you're real, real upset. He actually pulled that one from the archives.
Yeah, he was not happy with this.
He was not happy at all.
So it's some stories we couldn't tell on the air. That's the greatest story never told podcast.
And, of course, the mega cast is with Ted and Steve Miggs.
Is that story new to you?
Yeah. The podcast with Cobb and
MCTP.
MCTP and the Ted Smith. It's all there, plus the Men's Room radio channel. But listen to that the last couple days, man. There's some great tunes on there, different selections. They said, hey, pick 50 of your favorite songs apiece. That's what we did. We threw them all together. It's a mix of music. It's where the Q means variety. The Men's Room radio channel.
Yeah.
Right there on the Odyssey app. So hopefully we'll see you coming up at 6 o'clock for the Men's Room happy hour. And today, basically, if we could phrase the question the way we want to, as Mike said earlier, who effed up? How did they eff up? And why did they eff up? And why are they such an eff up?
Right.
But instead, we phrased it in a way that's FCC friendly. Who screwed up and how did they screw up? And we'll start with a story which is not even remotely comical. A demolition company was hired to tear down a house last week in Dallas, Texas. It mistakenly tore down a different home on the same street. Now, Jeremy Winninger, he inherited the 97-year-old house in a historic neighborhood when his friend Marianne died several years ago. I still cannot believe this. I cannot believe this actually happened. I cannot believe it's true. We did everything we could to save this home.
Almost.
Rest in peace, my dear friend, Marianne. Winnenberger lives in Los Angeles, but he stayed in contact with his old neighbors. He was in the process of planning renovations when someone called and told him that there was no longer a house to renovate. The owner of JR's Demolition, Bobby Lindemood, apologized about the incident in a press release. I, as the owner, have been in the demolition business for over 35 years, and after many thousands of structure demolitions, this is the first incident wherein the wrong structure was demolished.
But it won't be my last.
We made a mistake and thought we had the right property, so we owned up to it.
We believe you.
The problem is, when you own a company like that, it should be zero.
Right, exactly.
You demolish homes. Like, well, that's the first time we've done this. Like, well, you're good. Demolishing homes.
It's like, the cops are like, dude, you're being charged with murder. Hey, to be fair, it's the first person I've killed.
Yeah, first one, man.
He had multiple factors.
Just making my bones.
Right. Contributed to the mistake. The home did not have a house number due to heavy rain. The curb address was covered by water and debris. Lindemood also said that the home looked abandoned and in disrepair. The home was also similar in appearance and condition to other homes the company had already demolished on the street. Company is working on a resolution with Winninger.
What's the resolution to that?
I'm not sure.
I mean, pay for a new house, I guess? I don't know. Like, there's no real resolution. Like, guys, my house is gone. I believe you're sorry. I understand it was a mistake. Mm-hmm. No one questions that. But, like, I don't have a house.
Yeah.
You tore it down, man. Like, how do you make good on that? Just my bad.
Well, it's a house you're going to tear down. Like, I don't know. Like, let's double check. Right? What'd they say? The grass was overgrown or the bush? Like,
yeah,
they couldn't see the numbers that well? Like, you're going to demolish it. Like, double check it.
Sure.
Taking the pizza to the wrong house, forgivable. Tearing down the wrong house, like, that's bad, man.
Use Zillow on a map. Use anything.
Anything.
Google Maps.
You repo the wrong car. I could fathom it.
Mm-hmm.
You tore down their home.
It's just gone, man.
Now we go to Kenosha, Wisconsin.
I'm wondering, so the neighbors had to inform the guy that his house was no longer there.
I'm assuming that someone had to call him.
Like, you're demoing the house, you know what I mean, and you kind of hit the address plate, and someone looks you down and says, man, I don't think that's the right number, Hoss. You know, I don't know.
Yeah, who knows what the hell happened there. I don't know how that'll be resolved. So we go to Kenosha in Wisconsin, where police are conducting an internal investigation after officers placed the wrong man under arrest at an Applebee's restaurant in July. He was not feeling good in the neighborhood that day. But they ended up charging him for resisting arrest anyway. When a hit-and-run occurred on a nearby freeway about 11 o'clock at night, witnesses told law enforcement that two black men and a woman with a child had fled the scene on foot in the direction of an Applebee's, according to the outlet. Officers looking to apprehend them instead confronted a different man, woman, and baby seated at Applebee's forcefully.
What do you think he was eating?
If you're
at Applebee's, where are you getting? Riblets.
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 Oh, their chicken wings are pretty good.
Are they?
Oh, you know what? Applebee's, they are an appetizer superior restaurant.
Okay. All right.
They really do focus on the bar type food in a basket type of stuff.
I have not been to an Applebee's in 10,000 years. And after this story, maybe I don't go. But I wouldn't even know what to order other than the riblets.
The food is good. The beer selection is good. And one thing I like about Applebee's is it's affordable.
Yes.
So the one I went to in...
It is affordable.
One I went to in Florida, it was just a ton of food, big-ass beers, like, you know...
Was this last week you went?
Two times ago that I went.
Okay.
But I mean, like, the bartender's Applebee's say, you sure you don't want a 22-ouncer?
Like, I like that spirit.
Yeah, I do too. When you go to the bar, would you sure you don't want more alcohol?
Quick shout out to Dave and Buster's for having the same thing.
Yeah.
I ordered a beer. The chick was like, do you want 16 or 22 ounces? I just spread my hands out. She goes, 22 it is.
It's like Buffalo Wild Wings. They just want to make sure you got enough.
I've definitely been to a couple places where like the waitress would be like, 16, you want that 20? Like, yeah, just give it to me.
Yeah, it's cheaper, by the
way. Do I look like a guy that likes beer?
Mm-hmm.
Don't answer.
Right. So officers look to apprehend them instead of confronting the different man, woman, and baby. So they forcefully put the man in handcuffs. Meanwhile, the people the police were actually looking for were later found in the restaurant bathroom. So they were in the Applebee's.
So they're listening to all this going down.
Yeah. Authorities nonetheless charged both the man and the woman who were seated in the restaurant with disorderly conduct, resisting and obstructing an officer. The woman received an additional charge of possession of marijuana.
Oh, come on, man.
It's 11 o'clock at night. They got stoned. They went to Applebee's.
Right.
Big deal.
Right. So they go in. They got the wrong people.
Mm-hmm.
They say it's not us.
And the guy was adamant that it was not him.
Yeah.
And then they still got arrested for resisting arrest.
When I got arrested, the only charge they had, I didn't have a disorderly conduct, but when I got arrested, it was for resisting arrest. And I just, okay, fine, whatever. So you have your court date, I don't know, month later, whatever it is. And as the judge is reading this out loud, he started slowing down and shaking his head. Because he calls your name, he doesn't know who you are. There's 50 other people in there for different crimes.
Right, he's going through a bunch of them.
Stephen G. Hill, you're arrested for resisting arrest. I'm like, bro, look, I'm not trying to be a D about this, but if that's the only charge against me, you can count on that being the case every single time. Yes, I resisted arrest because I had not done anything.
Then what'd they say?
He threw it out. He threw it out and kind of scolded. The two officers were there. They were not there just for me. They had like five or six other people that they'd arrested for whatever reason. I don't know. But when the judge, you know, like, we're throwing this out.
Did they ask the officers why they arrested you in front of you?
No, they did not ask that in front of me.
Were you allowed to ask that question? Can you kind of represent yourself when you're in that situation?
Look, bro, at the moment that a judge says you can go, just want to go.
I understand.
I mean mug the cops when I was walking out just because maybe it had no effect on them, just made me feel better. But when they were arresting me, I did say, because I said to one of the arresting officers, we're like 12 there by the time it was all said and done. I'm like, dude, nobody's telling me what I'm being arrested for. It's walking home from work. That is where this confrontation began. What the F are you arresting me for? Words are exchanged, and finally the guy says, you're getting arrested for resisting arrest. I'm like, that's stupid. That doesn't even make sense. And then it got worse from there. But, you know.
Yeah. Can't drop logic. In the bystander footage of someone in the restaurant, the interrupted restaurant patron could be heard protesting, I'm not doing S. Let me the F go. As police cornered him next to the table. So he held onto his crying baby as officers tried to pry the child from him. One officer grabbed the baby, two others then tackled him as the man lay face down on the floor. Of course, the officer punched him repeatedly near or on his head, while the other man held his hands behind his back. The woman could be heard in the background of the video calling out for her child, but she was not captured on the video. Where the F is my child? She shouted. The baby then could be heard crying in the background throughout the video. The male was being detained as the crash was being investigated. The male attempted to leave against officers' orders and was restrained. He resisted, and the incident that was caught on camera unfolded from there, police told the Milwaukee Journal Sentinel.
My God, man. You're just trying to enjoy your freaking riblets.
Mm-hmm.
Next thing you know, you're being tackled by the cops, your kid snatched out of your hands. And then the guys that they're looking for are in the freaking bathroom.
So our question, who screwed up and how did they screw it up? 206-803-ROCK.
Hello, Alex. Welcome to the men's room.
Hola.
Hola. Hola.
Hello, gentlemen. All right. So I had another story, but me and my friend actually got kicked out of Canada.
You got kicked out of the country.
Yeah. We flew down there. Thought it was a good idea. You know, do some booger sugar and.
You do drugs?
Yeah. Right. Why not?
Ah. You just don't sound like somebody who would do that.
But we got there at like 2 a.m. and we showed up and we're trying to go through the border and they're asking us all these questions and they're like, yeah, what do you guys do? What, you know,
drugs.
Okay. Yeah, I mean, we couldn't tell them that, of course, but I didn't have a very valid answer. So they told
How do you not have a valid? Like, you could just lie. Like, what do you
have
do?
You heard this story?
I work in construction. I mean, anything, man. Just say a job.
I'm going to Vancouver for the night. I got a friend up.
What do I do? Hey, yeah, man. I don't know how to answer that.
Craving for Timbits.
Right.
I just told him that I was a producer of music. And
that's the job you picked.
You pick lawyer. You pick doctor. You
Jesus H. Christ. You pick.
I'm a roadie. I'm a carny.
I hate that. You know.
I'm a drug trafficker.
No. But anyway, they definitely flagged us and told us to pull over and they got the car out. They pulled us out and searched the whole car and. I didn't have my phone on. It was thankfully dead, but hers was on and they went through all of her messages and saw that, you know, the person that we'd been messaging and how it got everything and just pretty much knew everything.
Now, let me ask you this, producer of music, in your text with the booger sugar slinger, tell me you guys did not use code, and she's straight up like, we'll buy the cocaine from you.
Yep.
Are you kidding me? What happened? Come on, man. You got to have code words.
You do, man.
This plausible deniability.
The feds are in town. Haven't you heard all those old stories?
Right, I mean, my God.
I mean, my buddy would just call me up and go, the eagle has landed.
Right, exactly. Right. They would think we work for NASA. Has the eagle landed? Yes, the eagle has landed.
They had her. They had all of her information. They brought her in. They didn't have anything on me, and they were trying to get everything out of me. But I was just like, I don't know what you're talking about. You know,
I get the feeling they could have swabbed your cheek and been like, yeah.
These Canadian Border Patrol police were so rude. And he was just yelling at me, cussing at me in my face. I know what you effing did, and we know what you got. And I was just like, what?
I'm like, bro, I snorted it all. I promise you, I have no coke on me. It's all inside of my body.
I would not be suspicious about that guy at all.
No. Yeah, I'd pull him over right now.
No. I wouldn't even pull him out of the car. I'd be like, man, just do me a solid and make a U-turn.
Right, turn around.
And just turn around. Let's avoid.
Right.
Your girlfriend's too stupid to use code for a drug transaction.
Do they do that? I watch all those shows when people come through the borders with, like, drugs and stuff. Wonder if there's, like, because usually they go, you got to go to a second inspection.
Yeah.
But I like it if the border crosser just be like, dude, just go home.
We don't want you
in our country.
I had the window rolled down. We're in the pullover area.
Yeah.
And they bring this German Shepherd around. When you're coming back into the United States, this is coming back in. But I had my window rolled down because it was a hot summer day. We've been up there hanging out for a couple days. The dog's going around the car, keeps going around the car, and I leave my hand out. I'm like, oh, good looking dog, man. How are you? Don't talk to the dog. Do you think the dog understands anything I'm saying?
That was a game last night.
Right, exactly.
Do you like Scooby Snacks?
I mean,
the dog's fine. The dog is fine. It's on a mission.
Don't talk to the dog. Oh, why? Doesn't speak English? My bad. Right. Hola, my little amigo.
Hola, perro.
Yeah, exactly. Jesus. Who screwed up and how did they screw it up? 206-803-ROCK.
Therapy is known to be extremely helpful, but have you ever tried eavesdropping on someone else's problems? Listen to the new podcast, Say More with Dr. Sheila, starring Amy Poehler as the world-renowned self-proclaimed couples therapist.
My mother will come over when she says she will. Knowing that she's always going to be there is really nice for me because I don't have to make my own cereal.
Listen to Say More with Dr. Sheila on the free Odyssey app or wherever you get your podcasts.
Oh, 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 O'Reilly.
When you need auto parts, O'ReillyAuto.com is just a click away. We offer convenient options for you to get your parts, tools, accessories, and supplies quickly. Order online and pick up for free at your local O'Reilly Auto Parts store, or you can have your parts delivered right to your door with free shipping on most orders over $35. Visit O'ReillyAuto.com.
Oh, 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 O'Reilly Auto Parts.
99.9 KISW. The shenanigans continue. This is the Men's Room with Miles and Thrill.
Who screwed up? And how did they screw it up? 206-803-ROCK.
Hello, Terrell. Welcome to the Men's Room.
Can you guys hear me?
Hola.
Hola.
Oh man, Terrell! Hey, dude, your phone. We can't even understand you. Your phone's that
You on a Bluetooth or speaker or something like that, bud?
Because he asked if we could hear him when he first came on. So I wondered if.
Oh, and he's gone.
Give us a call back, man.
Okay,
just on a better phone, hopefully.
Yeah, it's some of the newer cars too. Not mine.
What year is your car?
07?
All right. Is that Bluetooth?
No.
Okay.
I can't even get the radio to work. But it's
still
haven't
gotten the radio to work.
No. I know. I've had like three friends. Even the guy that originally owned the car and bought it was like, hang on. I don't know if I can figure this out. I was like, it's all right. I got a cell phone. It's fine.
Does it not work or is it a weird way to turn it on? You've been going on about this radio since you got the
car. It's a weird
way
to turn it on and you have to like reset it, then override it, but then it like goes to the original dealership or this and that. Basically, there's no wheel rate we can figure out to recover it. Mm-hmm. But
car
manufacturer,
just make a radio that you hit on.
My annoyance at this point, though, is like it's like the like now when people get in and go, "Oh man, you're reading this," like effing try it, smart ass.
Yeah, yeah.
You'll be the fifth in a row.
Uh-huh. You might have to take it into the dealership.
Yeah, I mean, it's an 07.
At that point, I don't think that even they know how to.
It's got 330 miles, 100,000 miles on it.
You realize that's like the distance of the moon from Earth. Your car's basically driven to the moon.
But I was going to say, but it's good some of the newer cars have that stuff. Because I called my buddy Friday, and like this guy, like his, whatever, the Bluetooth or whatever wasn't connecting.
All right.
And I hear, and he goes, oh, sorry, this is better. You can hear me now. Let me put you on regular speaker. Oh, crap, I'm getting pulled over.
Oh, damn.
Oh, no.
As soon as he put it up to his ear, the state trooper was next to him.
Oh, man.
and so he didn't hang it up. He just dropped it. So I could hear it, and I hear him going, it wasn't working. I was going to put it on speaker. The cop was super nice about it. So then I see him later that night. I go, it wasn't expensive, but it wasn't a cheap ticket. I was like, sorry, man. He's like,
so you got the ticket. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, so if somebody that has an old car, like, don't use the phone.
Yeah, man, it sounds bad. Hello, Jessica. Welcome to the Men's Room.
Hola, bitches.
Hola.
Well, I work in the medical field, and my previous employer sold the practice to a new employer. Neither one of them are my employer now. The first one had a PIC line and was ordering and using hydro injections.
We don't know what that is exactly.
Hydromorphone. An opioid.
Okay.
Yeah.
Joy, she was using it for herself?
Yes.
Oh.
She had a PIC line, so it was a permanent IV.
Oh my God!
She had it hardwired in.
Track marks.
So there was so it was like a drip.
Connected to her heart, or it's like it ended in her heart, and yeah, it was. There's no need for track marks when you have a direct line.
Jesus God, man.
Yeah.
How long was she doing that? Do you think?
easily a couple years, apparently.
So when you look,
I heard after she left.
When you look back on that, were there any warning signs that you see now that she basically was just tripping bees all the time?
Yeah, there's a lot of red flags looking back now.
Okay, well, let me ask you a question. What kind of doctor was she?
I'm not going to say because it's a small community. And
I understand.
Yeah. But
she was like a brain surgeon or anything.
But she was ordering it under the person who she sold the practice to under his DEA license. And now they're both screwed.
Yeah, so that's bad.
But did that dude have anything to do with her at all?
I mean, they slept together a little bit here and there, apparently. Okay. But he never kept track of the DEA, and now he never paid attention and caught on that she was ordering all this hydro, and we weren't using it at the hospital.
It's safe to say that she kept track of his DNA.
Yes.
Wow, man.
That's
so
crazy.
She had it hooked up directly to her heart.
Essentially, yeah.
It's amazing she's still alive.
Yeah, good point.
Yeah, yeah.
Now, are you still in the medical field?
Oh, yeah, yeah, no. I found the shipment and went, well, we didn't order this, and it all spiraled out from there.
The only people that they were hurting, seemingly, at that time was themselves. So what is the biggest slip-up that you've ever seen just in the medical community in general as far as
whether drop a scalpel or someone's open gut?
Or a story that you've heard where someone, man, they left a pair of tongs in somebody. Or,
operated on the wrong knee.
Right.
Well, I will say veterinary field, so it's kind of hard to say.
Yeah, the dogs can't talk back very much.
Yeah.
Okay, now let me ask this. I'm not saying you would do this, but dog goes in for whatever surgery. I don't know what it's for. But either way, something goes wrong. Fluffy doesn't make it out of there. Is it easier to lie and just say, even if it was like your fault, would you tell someone that? Or would you say, oh, man, they didn't respond well to the anesthesia? Because let's face it, we don't know. Mm-hmm. I'm going to take your word. Didn't respond to the anesthesia and Fluffy's not coming home. Or would you tell them, hey, man, we messed up and this is what happened?
No, usually we cop to it to be as delicate as possible, but we try to be as honest as possible. And, I'm not the doctor, so the doctor, it's all on the doctor on how we handle it.
I know somebody who worked for a long time in that field, and they basically said that every once in a while, like anything else, you bring in an animal, you bring in your dog, you bring in your cat, whatever the deal is, and they say, look, just to maintain the animal's health and, it's betterment in life, the animal needs a surgery. The surgery, say, $4,000, $5,000. And a couple of times, the person will step outside to make a phone call to their significant other or whoever.
Sure.
And just, go through the process. Do we want to put the animal down? Or do we want to pay?
For $300.
Do we want to pay for this thing? But they would never come back. So they they wouldn't answer their phone.
So what do you do?
Veterinary, the technicians at times will want to adopt the animal, and there's a substantially lower fee if the person who's working there is the owner and perform.
Okay, right. The family discount.
Yeah. There's a lot of people who would come in and save animals. That owner never even knew that their dog wasn't put down, but it was rehomed.
But they just make the assumption that they put it down.
If you're not going to come back and you don't care, then they don't care.
I mean, technically, as a kid, my dog went to the farm. I never saw his dead little body.
we'll call animal control and say, hey, somebody left their dog or cat. Pick it up.
Honestly, are those really your dog's ashes? Or is it just, hey, take a big scoop out of the pit of hell and stick it in a box with somebody? Because we've already cremated, 25 animals today in this damn thing. It's not like they individually scoop the ashes out. That's like saying, like, every time you build a fire, you take the ashes out.
Right.
Every two or three times you do.
Yeah, I have heard of that happening.
Yeah.
And that's another story for another time.
I know I've got multiple dogs in that box sitting in the closet. All right, let me ask you this, Jessica. What is the weirdest animal someone has brought in?
Oh, I only work with cats and dogs, but Chinese crested's pretty weird looking.
What is the Chinese crest?
It's a dog, and it's like Chihuahua size, and it's practically naked. It has ear hair and some pom poms on its wrists, and it's just weird looking.
Well, also there's a couple practices in the area that have rather large.
Oh God, I just googled the picture. They are stupid looking dogs. Look at this dumbass thing. I like dogs, I do, but I'd be pissed if someone brought that home to me.
Looks like a gremlin. There's a couple places that have big enough...
Gremlins aren't cute.
Big enough MRI machines where, you know, the Woodland Park Zoo will bring in a bigger animal.
Yeah.
Or the Seattle Aquarium will bring in a big-ass turtle, sea turtle.
Right.
Or, you know, so they're running water over this damn thing and all that craziness and then shoving it through an MRI. And, you know, the turtle doesn't tell anybody in there that it had knee replacement. It's got metal in its knee. Next thing you know, it's... Ah!
Oh, damn, really?
No.
MRI
will rip you up, though. But depending on the size of it, I've seen those pictures of, like, you know, whether it was a big cat or whatever the deal is at the zoo. You know, like, it's on the table. It's got tubes in its mouth, teeth hanging out.
Yeah, like, keep that thing asleep.
Please. You just, you know, the anesthesia.
Have you seen the videos when they do it with the sharks?
No. What do they do with the sharks?
There's, like, I mean, they're tagging them, but I think they're checking them, too. So it's like a boat. They, like, catch the shark, and then there's, like, a platform, right, that's already lowered into the water. Think like a wooden deck.
Okay.
Probably not wood.
Probably not, yeah.
But once the shark's on there, they, like, I guess they tranquilize him or something, but the deck comes up, he's like, out of the water, and they shove this giant, like, water tube in his throat and through his gills so they can, like, work on the shark, but he's still, like, breathing water.
Not only that, but I was on...
You think when it's all said and done, right, and the shark kind of gets its senses back and it's swimming through the ocean, is it, like... What in that is it the equivalent of being abducted by an alien for a human being? Like, you're looking at other sharks like, bro, I do not know what to tell you. I swear to God, they put tubes in my gills in my mouth, and they're like, you're a crack.
I bet that shark, because he's tranquilized, right? It's like, when I've had a couple surgeries, like, the first one I had, I woke up and I said, why does my throat hurt?
Right.
And the nurse is like, we had a giant tube in there. So the shark has no idea.
Half the time, the shark's not really going through a procedure as much as it's going through a... Now, if they have an embedded hook or something that can physically be being taken care of, yes, but they're tagging those sharks. So the reason that they're keeping the water running through them like that is so they're staying alive during the tagging.
No, I get that. I'm just saying when it's done, the shark has to be like, what in the hell just happened?
Yeah, and why am I swimming? Why am I wearing this thing?
I got this weird memory, man. I swear to God, like, there were people around me. They had tubes in my mouth. They're like, sure, buddy.
That's how they figure out migration patterns, mating things, and all those different things. Because I used to track, when I was on Twitter.
You're not tracking the shark anymore?
I'm not on Twitter anymore, but I used to follow, like...
You can still track one other stuff.
I used to follow, like, 30 of them. I might have to check that out, because I really enjoyed, like, look at that guy go.
You follow 30 different sharks.
I did, because they all had really ridiculous names. It was almost like, you know, like, you know, like Bodie McBoatface.
That kind of thing.
They would give them, you know, ridiculous name, like, you know, like Bruce the Man or whatever. Just follow him. Like, damn, man, he's in Massachusetts. Like, last week he was in the Carolinas. This guy's hauling ass. Who screwed up and how did they screw it up? 206-803-ROCK.
Hello, Scott. Welcome to the men's room.
Hola.
Hola. Hola.
All right. I am in the flooring industry, so I sell, like, carpet and hard surface flooring, and I sold two different customers, two different types of hard surface flooring, like luxury vinyl plank. And then when I went to have them installed, I accidentally swapped the colors and sent the wrong colors to both products to the wrong customers, and they installed them before I even recognized there was a problem.
How significant was the color differential?
It was about medium. Like, it was noticeable if you had one next to the other.
Well, also, if you're the homeowner, having just gone through this, you would know, like, this is not what I ordered.
Did either of them notice? Yeah. Did either of the two parties notice?
No.
Okay, that's what I was going to say.
How long did you give it before you figure? Okay, they absolutely don't know. Is it like 2 weeks? Like, you're just waiting for that phone call?
So I have them both installed. They were installed on the same day, and then after they were installed, the trim showed up, and the trim was for the correct colors that they had actually ordered. So now my trims aren't going to match the floor, and the guys installed it all anyway. And both customers contacted me the same day and said, we love our floors. They look beautiful. And we love that the transitions are a little bit different so that they kind of highlight the floors.
Oh. Well, so basically, they think you're kind of a design genius, I mean, and appreciate
so
you.
So did you? Have you ever suggested that to another client? You know, it doesn't look bad. Okay, all right. Okay.
No.
If you want to change that corner around a little bit, you know, you got a different kind of a feel.
Yeah, did not do that. I was so fortunate. It would have cost us like $8,000 or $9,000 to redo it.
Okay.
Yeah, easily. So I'm glad both clients were real happy with that incredible transition you did for their beautiful floors.
Hey, do me a favor if you get a chance, man. Text in that you're the carpet guy, and I'll text you back because I need carpet put in my steps, and I haven't heard back from Batman.
Okay, I'll do that.
Yeah, please. I appreciate it.
Okay.
Yeah, I wish he'd called about a year ago.
Well, we just I know it's going to take a year later for him to go, hey, man. And I'll be like, at that point,
got your call. I called you 12 months ago. Yeah, but I got it.
Go to a Crockett game.
There you go.
Yeah, I'm on it. Just call this guy. He's my guy. Who screwed up and how did they screw it up? 206-803-ROCK.
Hello, Connor. Welcome to the men's room.
Hola.
Hola.
Yeah, so when I was about six, I had, it's my first memory, honestly, one of my first memories. I had this babysitter and she had gotten her license that week and she was really gung-ho about driving. So she took me to 7-Eleven, and when we were leaving, she thought the car was in reverse, and it was in drive.
Oh, Lord.
And she drove the entire car into 7-Eleven to the point where I was in the back seat, and if I opened my window, I could have grabbed, like, a bag of chips.
Well, I mean, when in Rome.
So what is the next step after that, man, as you're just sitting in the back? Did you have to wait through the whole thing for the cops to show up and all that kind of thing?
Yeah, I was in the back. I really didn't know what was going on. I mean, I knew it was bad. I was like six. I knew it was bad. I knew the car shouldn't have been there. The owner. I remember the owner of the 7-Eleven being super nice about it. I remember someone got cut by glass, like standing outside the store. But it was like one of my earliest memories. I just remember being in the 7-Eleven and they had to tow the car out.
Did they offer you any snacks?
Oh, yeah, the guy gave me a Slurpee, and I think he gave me a Slurpee and, like, a lollipop or something.
Okay, all right.
Because you're sitting in a car that somebody drove into his name store.
Right, but if that's going to happen to your store, a 16-year-old with babysitting a 6-year-old, it's like, you're super pissed, but it's like...
Right. So what happened? Did your parents come and get you? Was she able to drive the car?
They came and got me, and that was the last day that she watched me.
Yeah, I was going to ask if she ever got another chance.
Yeah, that was it for her. That was a trial run, and she failed.
Oh, look, man, my 16-year-old daughter, if she said, Dad, I'm going to drive down my 6-year-old cousin.
No.
No, you're not.
No.
I'll come and pick your ass up.
Right.
You can drive on your own. I'll go pick up the car. Yeah. I do not, 16 years old, don't they have rules against even just having your friends in the car? Or maybe it's 15. I don't know what the deal is.
I mean, it depends on what happened, too. Like, I didn't have any of those rules, but I know in the last, 15, 20 years, maybe. They seem to have put them in. But also, it ain't like 16-year-olds, when there's no parents around, don't still do it.
Exactly.
Oh, yeah. I know.
Look, man, if you have a vehicle, something illegal is going to happen. You know, you're the first buddy to get a car, and there's, you know, the party down the street. 8 of you want to go. It's a 4-seater. Well, open the trunk. There's 3 of you in the trunk. I mean, it's like, right, everything about it's illegal.
Everybody pitches in 50 cents for gas.
For gas, you know, right.
You put in like $3, maybe.
Smallest people go in the trunk.
I mean, you think of stuff you do in college, right? Miles, if I showed up to your house, we're going to go see a show on a Saturday night. I show up at 4 and go, let's split this fifth of vodka. Shots of it. Right. You'd be like, that seems a little aggressive. Like, why don't we go to the bar and get like a beer and a shot? Like, no, let's just chug this cheap vodka before we go.
And you
go,
my grandfather, he gave me his old car when he bought a new one.
All right.
But the way that he did his car world, his gas never got below halfway on the tank.
Right.
So I remember him coming over and saying, hey, I just want to take the old car for a test drive, blah, blah, blah. Just drive around, see how it's driving, see if I can notice anything. I mean, he drives my car to the gas station. And I'm like, you know, on a quarter tank of gas. He fills the tank up. Then he still has his old ledger of gas records.
Oh, my God.
In the glove compartment that he did by hand with a pen. As far as the mileage goes.
How far he got.
Yeah. How far and how, you know, and how much it was a gallon. What station he was at. And he'd fill it in with like a 6-month gap in between.
Right.
You know, there's been like, you know, 3,000 miles been put on this car in the meantime. And he'd just go right back in and filled your car up. And be like, yes.
That's the great thing about it.
Yes. Who screwed up and how did they screw it up? 206-803-ROCK.
Experience what your customer experiences with user testing. Whether you're launching a new product, prototype, or marketing campaign, you'll get real-time video feedback straight from the source. The User Testing Human Insight Platform lets you understand it all from your customer's perspective. You can target your exact audience, ask questions, and get a window into their world. The result? You feel what your customer feels so you can build the best experience imaginable. For a free trial, visit usertesting.com/audio.
When things feel a bit chaotic, Instacart helps deliver milk and sausage at
add a little life to your cart. Get stuff from literally all your stores, from baby wipes to albacore. Add a little life to your cart. Instacart helps get your groceries. Your first three deliveries are free.
Download Instacart. Add life to cart. Terms apply.
Looking to give the gift of pleasure? Add a little high heat to keep the desire burning. Or maybe you just need a little self-care. Come to Lovers for the best lingerie and toys to keep things hot this holiday. Save 20% on your purchase with Lovers Afterglow Rewards. Just mention LOVE20 at one of our 18 Western Washington locations. Offer valid with free Lovers Afterglow Rewards membership until November 30th. Some exclusions apply.
What's up? It's your boy, the Ted Smith from The Men's Room. And did you know I have a podcast? Well, I do. The Podcast. New episodes uploaded every Wednesday on the Odyssey app.
9.9 KISW. We return to The Men's Room with Miles and Thrill.
A burrito thrown by a woman at a Florida restaurant missed its intended target. Instead, hitting a male victim in the face. Well, they're very similar to the movie with Nick Cage, right?
The Weatherman or something. Yeah, right. But at least they were targeting him.
Yeah, but wasn't it a burrito?
Yeah, it was burrito.
It was a burrito in the face, yeah.
Will Ferrell?
Yeah. For some reason, I thought that was Nick Cage.
It wasn't Nick Cage. No, Will Ferrell was eating a delicious burrito, and he threw it out the window at a motorcycle rider, and he ended up...
No, that was
Anchorman.
Anchorman.
Right, that was Jack Black.
Yeah, there's
he got hit in the head because he was a weatherman, apparently gave the wrong forecast, and people get mad at him.
And people made a point to track him down. And
is that right, Ted?
You're both right.
Okay. Yes.
Right. I got your reference. That is the weatherman where he gets pelted with a burrito, but Mike's not wrong. Will Ferrell does throw a burrito out.
All right.
Knock over a motorcyclist, Jack Black. Who then throws his dog, Baxter, off a bridge.
Did he kick the dog off or throw it off?
Did he drop kick him?
He dropped.
Yeah, I think he dropped kick him.
Oh,
yeah.
Miles knows.
But then Baxter swam.
Based loosely on a true story.
Oh, you're back.
Now, you know what? That joke landed, but I just meant because it's a kicker thing.
Yeah, right.
Landed. I get it.
Right. Yeah, well, definitely wasn't a drop kick. It was a punt. drop kicking is hard.
Right, the dog would be the ball has to bounce off the ground.
Yeah, you're never going to see it in your entire football viewing career. I don't care what level you're watching, college football, high school, pro. You will never see a drop kick for a point in your lifetime. You have more of a chance of being
Doug Flutie,
billionaire.
Patriots.
Mm-hmm. He did it.
Yep.
Did you see it?
Yeah, it was like, what, 2000, early 2000s?
I mean, Chad Ochocinco could do it because he's kind of a soccer star. But other than that, I can't think of any time it's ever happened. I just didn't see it.
Wasn't there also a point when I think the Seahawks kicker, whether it was Sebastian Janikowski or maybe even like Hauschka was having a bad day, they brought Dixon out for an extra point? Didn't he try a drop
maybe,
kick to do that?
Maybe.
I don't know. I just Googled it, right? The last and only successful drop kick in the NFL was by Doug Flutie for the Pats against the Dolphins in 06.
And that's a three-pointer, I'm going to assume.
Yeah.
You put it through the uprights, it's got to be three, right? Well, investigators were called Wednesday evening to Rick's Reef at St. Pete Beach due to female subject yelling at customers. The woman in question, Sarah Kakura, 46, who lived with her boyfriend at the condo down the road from Rick's. A witness told police that she was in a verbal dispute with a man not identified in an arrest affidavit. At one point, she threw a burrito at the subject, but the airborne burrito did not strike the man who she was quarreling with. Instead, the Mexican delicacy hit the victim in the face. Now, the affidavit does not indicate whether the victim was injured by the burrito.
No, but pissed.
Yeah. She then departed the restaurant before cops could arrive, but she remained nearby and was not cooperative with deputies. She was charged with disorderly conduct and booked into the county jail and was out early Thursday morning after posting $250 bond. Her LinkedIn profile lists her as a financial advisor with a financial services company in the Tampa Bay area.
A financial advisor. And you're throwing burritos, people.
Yeah. She was also arrested last month for allegedly punching her 66-year-old boyfriend in the face during an argument at their place. The victim, cops reported, had a red mark over his right eye, consistent with a closed fist punch. Prosecutors subsequently declined to pursue a domestic battery case against her, a decision that came 2 weeks after Her boyfriend requested that the misdemeanor count be dropped and a judicial no-contact order against her be erased. So he was just fine with getting beat up with his girlfriend, who later went and threw a burrito in a woman's face.
And missed. Yes. And hit someone else.
That's not what I'm thinking when I'm going to Rick's Reed.
Boy, I'd be pissed off. Like, look, man, I know you're mad. I know people do dumb things, but, like, you got to hit your target, man.
This is definitely...
You just hit me in the face with a burrito.
This is back to yesterday's topic. It's definitely a wrapped burrito. She's throwing it, right?
I would think so, yeah.
It's not just one she picked off a plate and hurled.
Well, if it's not wrapped, I think it's just a taco, brother.
Okay.
You know, I kind of hope
I
she
grabbed...
I mean,
wrapped with paper. You know what I mean? Like, in the aluminum foil.
Right, I was like, I think that's what makes a burrito a burrito.
I feel like if you got hit with a burrito that was like a table burrito that did not have a wrapper on it.
You're going to get a lot of splatter.
It's going to splatter.
Sure.
But the one that's wrapped, it's kind of more like a brick.
I'm kind of hoping deep down that she grabs someone else's burrito. Like, she's that pissed off, grabbed it off of someone else's plate.
Right. It's like throwing a gyro without a wrapper on it.
Right.
You're just going to throw a bunch of crap in the air.
By the way,
Rick's Reef sounds like a solid beach bar.
Yeah, like, just have a good time, not get hit with burritos.
You know, look, I'm sure there's been a few fights in there.
You know what? At Rick's Reef, you're right. If there's a place you're going to get hit in the face with an errant burrito, Rick's Reef, probably Rick's Reef over, say, Daniel's Broiler.
Yeah, and I'm going to say cilantro lime shrimp burrito.
It burns my eyes. Ooh. And by the way, we got corrected, guys. With the Weatherman movie, Nicolas Cage was hit with a hot apple pie from McDonald's, and someone else hit him with a Frosty from Wendy's. But it was not a burrito.
He got hit with a lot of stuff, didn't he?
He did. For some reason, I always thought burrito. I don't know.
Rick's Reef's got fried fish. They've got steamed shrimp, burgers.
Yeah.
Tacos. I'm just trying to find the burrito to see what the presentation is. Ribs. They got just about everything. Onion rings.
Hot dogs.
This place is
hooking up. Burrito? I want to see big is it?
Is that the burrito? No.
No, that's not a burrito.
That's stuffed fish. I'm going to look at this burrito here and find out what that woman got hit in the face with.
Goddamn, they have a lot of food. Just show a picture of the burrito.
Yeah,
just want to see the burrito.
They probably took it off here because they don't want the bad publicity.
I apologize. No, maybe we were wrong. I thought it was the burrito too, but the only thing coming up is what Mike said.
Yeah.
Anchorman.
Okay, Nicolas Cage, not hit with burritos.
I guess
burritos
pitch perf.
So delicious, but so filling.
They got tacos. Just don't see a burrito. Our question, who screwed up and how did they screw it up? 206-803-ROCK.
Hello, Michael. Welcome to the men's room.
Hola, my friend.
Hola.
Yeah, okay. Well, anyway, I got a 97 Sebring convertible, pretty mint condition. It had a few miles on it, but anyway, the AC went out on it last year, and I went in to have it serviced. Anyway, my brother said, yeah, I know a good mechanic, take it here. So I took it to this shop, and the guy said, yeah, we'll have it done, just give us a day with it, no problem. I said, okay. So anyway, I go home, everything's all fine, said, done, and the next day I called, I said, is my car done? He goes, no, we had to order a couple of parts. So I said, fine. Just call me when it's done. Anyway, 4 days had passed on by, and, you know, I was getting a little upset, of course. I mean, how long does it take to charge an AC? Not very long, I would think. Anyway, I told the mechanic, I said, well, how much did it cost? And he goes, it'll be something like $8,500,
$8,600. $8,500? The card's not worth that much.
$8,000, yeah. But I'm like, excuse me, I'm coming in to get my car and we'll talk about it. So I came in and the guy showed me the invoice on what he did, the mechanic that worked on it. He said, well, yeah, you know, I replaced the motor and the transmission. I go, this is not my invoice. My invoice is right here for it. Red on black, black top, red car, Sebring convertible. There's my license plate on the invoice. And what does that say? He says, and he just looked at it. And his jaw dropped, and I went, yeah, wrong car, right, guy? And he goes, oh, gosh. So he goes, you got a couple minutes, and he called his boss, and his boss was there in 20 minutes. And the next thing I know, his boss comes in, he goes, man, I am so, so sorry about this.
He goes, I go, he replaced my motor and transmission. Why? You know, I didn't put that on there. And he goes, oh, gosh. Well, you got a new motor and a transmission, and we're not going to charge you for the AC charge, but your AC charge works.
Was it a brand new motor?
They put in a new motor and a new transmission.
Well, you win. That's the best screw up ever.
Yeah, they didn't have to pay for it.
I didn't.
Yeah, that's
a dime.
Even your AC, they even put that on the house.
They put that on the house, too. And he said, please don't report this.
All right.
It'll ruin my business.
Okay.
And he brought the mechanic in right in front of me and said, you're fired.
Damn.
All right, let me ask you a question.
It works out for you.
How's that car running these days?
Like it was new.
Okay. Because I had a buddy who had one. He was very angry with that.
I do not enjoy Sebrings.
No.
I'll leave it
That was like you got in and it felt like you were in a rattle trap.
Everything just
shake, rattled, and rolled.
It's like if you could fit inside of a Hot Wheel car, that's the sense I got with that car. By the way, Miles, someone here says, your burrito fact-checking is amazing.
Well, I'm just trying to find out, was it a wrap burrito?
By the way, just to be honest with you, man, Miles went through every picture they have of food at Rick's Reef. They have a picture of everything except a burrito.
Yeah.
Everything. We want to see the size of the burrito that this woman potentially threw. They don't have a single picture. Hmm. It had to be 100 pictures you went through, right?
I'm still looking for a burrito.
Hello, Laura. Welcome to the men's room.
Hello.
Hola.
Hi. So I dated a guy for almost 3.5 years, and I was in school, and I came home early to surprise him, and he was in the military. He was a submariner, and I found him with his shipmate.
Oh, with his shipmate.
Yes.
Were they in the act when you showed up?
Yes, they were. Definitely in the act.
Okay.
How awkward is that moment?
It was terrible. I just felt anger and rage at the moment and just pure shock.
Well,
So you had no idea.
Yeah, I would say all of those things are probably the right way to feel.
Mm-hmm. Well, cheating on anyone's never a good thing. That's a fact. Is it different when you realize, look, this person was just not attracted to the opposite sex?
Or attracted to both?
Yeah, well, could be that, too.
It was a shock that he wasn't attracted to, my sex, female.
Yeah, well, I would think so, too, because you were dating him.
Yeah, I mean, for 3 years.
You kind of just assumed that was the way it went. Did you know the guy? The other guy?
Yeah. Yes, I did. We've been to many parties with him and his wife multiple times.
Oh, God. So he's married.
Did she find out?
Yes, she did. I videoed it and sent it to her.
Wait a minute. So they weren't aware that you were there at the time for a while? You had enough time to video it before you confronted them?
The time I had was hearing noises. And then I turned my phone on and started videoing.
All right, I got to ask, as far as the baseball world goes, was your boyfriend the pitcher or was he the catcher?
He was a catcher.
All right, okay. I'm just curious,
You videotaped. So how long did this continue to go? After you opened the door, you have a phone in your hand. I mean, I would assume they stopped immediately.
About 10 seconds after they turned around and saw me.
So you have 10 good seconds before they notice.
And what did he say other than
He didn't say anything until after I did bring out a cast iron frying pan. Didn't do anything, but his shipmate did run out of our house.
Did he run out naked?
Yeah, his pants were around his ankles.
Okay,
was this like on like a base or something? Was it like? Could people see this like guy like running out of your house?
No, I live in Bremerton, so it was a good 5 minutes from the base is where our house was.
Okay.
Now, did you own the house together, or were you just renting it?
I was renting under my name.
Okay. All right. So I guess you just told him that he needed to leave.
Exactly.
Okay.
I'm sure that's exactly how you.
Did you ever run into him again?
No, I haven't.
All right. Okay. Well, it sounds like you found someone else based on what you got.
Or you kidnapped someone.
Somebody we don't know.
Yeah. Something worked out in your favor. Damn.
Wow.
Surprise.
Man.
Wow. Okay.
That would be
Like, man, oh, man. That's
Oh, yeah.
Well, they say, how do you stay out that long at sea? You
know? Yeah. Now we know. Billy. You're looking good, brother. Periscope up.
That's just weird.
Yeah, man.
Right, because, like, you're right. You don't want your significant other cheating on you with anybody.
Mm-hmm. Right.
And then, yeah, that's even strange. Like,
and he's the catcher. Somehow,
yeah, he just mind at ease.
I just would have been like, why did you not tell me?
Like, I'd be okay with
it. Yeah, like, why are you dating me? But with that said, I talked to a guy once on a plane. He was gay, and he was telling me how he was married and stuff. And I said, well, how did your wife find out? And he goes, I kind of took the easy way out. I just left gay porn up on my computer.
Really?
On purpose.
On purpose. And he was like, she was really mad for a couple of years. He's like, now it's cool, and we all get along, and we all hang out with the kids and stuff. But he was like, I wanted to get caught. He was just like, I couldn't do it anymore.
Yep. Well, that'll do the trick.
That makes sense.
God, I remember when I first started dating my now wife, she had this roommate, and I can't even describe a roommate. Anyway, her roommate was in a relationship with this dude, another military guy, and I'd met him a few times, and I remember telling my wife, I'm like, look, he's nice enough, but I'm telling you, there's just something about this guy. You know, I don't know what it is. She's like, oh, you're overthinking it. I'm like, maybe. I'm just telling you, man, my spidey sense is going off. So before we moved out here, we're at her place, and like, you have a computer I can use. I'm trying to get all this stuff done, getting this job set up. And I sit down at the computer, and this is the old desktop style, and I'm typing something. I was like, babe, come here for a minute, man. Because the computer I'm on was normally used by this guy. Now, there was nothing on screen that indicated what he might be up to. And I said, listen, this guy, I'm telling you, man, he's making sex videos for people. She's like, oh, my God, why would you say that? I said, I'm going to tell you why I say that. Because when you sit in this chair, we're all the same height, right?
Mm-hmm.
And there's your webcam. And I realize, as I'm on the computer, the webcam's aimed directly at my groin. And I said, why do you think it would be aimed there? Most people put it up to their face. You're having a conversation. Yep. You aim it at your groin because you're not doing a whole lot of talking. You're doing a whole lot of showing. Again, she blows me off. Then about 2 weeks later, she's like, yep, proved to be true. Roommate Connie walked in, busted him. punching the clown, if you will, for another dude who was punching his clown. Basically, they're watching each other.
All right.
I was like, I tried to tell you this, man.
Jeez.
That's why the webcam's aimed at the seat of the chair. But yeah, so I guess her roommate walked in, and he's in there. I mean, just going to town, and she recognized the other guy.
My weirdest thing, though.
You want to hop online? Yeah. Have a little fun?
Sure, man.
My roommate, Jamie, he was a nurse, and he had like 4 or 5 boyfriends. He was just one of those guys. Right. Like, he played the field. He was young. He was a bodybuilder.
Sure.
He was but he would shave his entire body.
Like, all right.
I mean, head to toe, because he was one of those bodybuilders. I mean, he was really well put together and everything. And I'm in the living room one day, and he's in his bedroom. He's like, Miles, I need you to come in here. And I'm like, Jamie, what the hell's going on? So I go in there. He used to take steroids. All right. He had injected himself in the ass, bent over, and just popped because he was a nurse.
Right.
So the needles really didn't bother. But the way he went in with the needle broke off inside of his ass.
Oh.
Okay.
So what are you supposed to do?
All right. So what I had to do was, I had to go to the... We didn't have tweezers. These were colleges.
Right.
I mean, honest to God, you just think you'd have normal things.
You got salad tongs, bro.
At that point, if you asked me if I had a screwdriver there, I'd be like, no, I don't have a screwdriver.
Yeah, nothing.
Like, I don't have anything. But so I went to the GNC or whatever the drugstore was, got some tweezers, the Rite Aid, came back, and he was thumbing it and trying to wedge it. And it, I mean, it was 2 inches of needle in his ass.
Was any of it out?
Yeah. So I had to grab onto a smooth-ass butt cheek because he used to shave on it. And I had to push down on it like I was going to pop a pimple. You know what I'm saying? And
try to pressure it back out.
Yeah, pressure it up. And then I saw the head pop up a little bit. I'm like, oh, man, I got this thing. So I started yanking on it, but the needle kind of it bent when it went in.
Yeah.
But I finally yanked that damn thing out, man. And when I yanked it out, blood just kind of like went all over my chin.
Ow!
Because I'm down in there.
Right.
I'm trying to, like, get it. It was like, it was just like this one that wasn't like a streak. It didn't bleed after that.
But you got
like,
butt blood on you.
Oh, it was like a, like someone who's using a small paint gun.
Right.
You know what I mean? I'm just like, God.
My bro, you owe me for this.
But it was so weird to grab another man's bare ass. He's a traditionally hairy guy.
Right.
But so his ass was kind of in a stubbly phase.
Oh, God.
It was like the George Michael.
Yeah.
He's Italian, dude. You know? But either way, like.
It's like cradling George Michael's face.
And his ass was a muscle, man. Like,
did you never have to help him, like, tan it?
No.
mean, that's kind of, you got to put on full body.
What was you going to say to Miles's face now?
No. No, but just grabbing onto his ass on my knees, you know what I mean? Trying to pull this freaking needle out of him, man. And I'm just like, this is. And then he bent. Well, it helped when he bent over.
Oh, God.
Because when he bent over, it kind of started to also help push the needle out a little bit more.
Yeah, it helps him.
Right, exactly.
You're just like, man, that's enough bending.
But the weird thing is, when I got it, I felt a real sense of success. Like, I got it! I got it!
Yay!
Yeah, well, I mean, you helped him out.
Yeah. I'm pretty sure it was like a mixture of steroids and blood that shot in my face. You know? It's like a Diabol blood combination or something.
Who screwed up and how did they screw it up? 206-803-ROCK.
I'm Snoop Dogg, and I'm giving up smoke. I know what you're thinking. Snoop, smoke is kind of your whole thing. But I'm done with it. I'm done with the coughing and my clothes smelling all funky. I'm going smokeless. Solo stove, fixed fire. They took out the smoke. Now you can have a nice blaze without any clouds ruining your day. Go smokeless. Go to solostove.com. Tell them Big Snoop Dogg sent you.
Are you dealing with a personal injury? Don't go it alone. Turn to the experienced team at Phillips Law Firm. Their attorneys have helped thousands of clients get the compensation they deserve. Call Phillips Law Firm now. Call 1-800-JUSTICE or visit justiceforyou.com.
Getting older means a world of change, but some things still stay the same, like being at risk for type 1 diabetes, because type 1 can happen at any age. So screen it like you mean it. If just one person in your family has type 1, you're up to 15 times more likely to get it too. And 50% of type 1 diagnoses happen after the age of 18. So screen it like you mean it. Type 1 diabetes starts long before you need insulin, and one blood test could help you spot it early and lower the risk of serious complications like diabetic ketoacidosis, known as DKA. So don't get caught by surprise. Screen it like you mean it, because getting answers now can help you get prepared. The more you know, the more you can do. So don't wait. Talk to a doctor about how to get screened. Tap now or visit screenfortype1.com to learn more. Again, that's screenfortype1.com. And screen it like you mean it.
OXO takes pride in making every day better, so you can feel better about doing big tasks like this. And this. Even this. We're all doing better because OXO partners with 1% for the Planet and donates 1% of its sales to community food programs. So every OXO product you buy helps enrich food systems around the world. For the many things we do, we're all doing better for the planet. OXO and 1% for the Planet, doing better.
99.9 KISW. The Men's Room returns with Miles and Thrill.
24 first responders helped rescue a cemetery worker who became trapped in a grave on Tuesday afternoon. The incident.
Wait, what?
He was trapped in a grave.
He's the grave digger.
I think he was a cemetery worker. I'm not sure exactly what he was doing.
Coming up on headlines.
Okay.
The incident happened at the Holy Cross Cemetery on Cranberry Road about 1 o'clock in the afternoon.
I bet you called it Holy something else after that.
A funeral service had just wrapped up when the 47-year-old worker fell through a wood board about 6 feet down into an open grave. Apparently, he separated his shoulder, leaving him injured and unable to move. So crews worked to shore up the hole so they could get him out. Rescue technicians were deployed. They deployed trench panels and ground pads to stabilize the area and around the pit. Then they used a rope system to get the man out of the grave and turn him over to the EMS. It took some time to make sure that everything worked out. He was rescued shortly after about an hour and a half and was alert and taken to the hospital. Our question, who screwed up and how did they screw it up? 206-803-ROCK.
Miles, I'm going to share with you a few texts that came in based on your, hey, I helped my buddy get the needle out of his butt story.
I did.
Let's see. It says that Miles is one hell of a friend. Miles always has the most horrifying stories. Someone else says, I'm going to crash my car listening to Miles tell the story, but this one I enjoy the most. It says, my buddy told me that his ass used to be so hairy that he took a dump one time, and it just laid in his butt hair like a hammock. His wife went in there and trimmed them all up. Wife of the year.
Well, the other part of the story that I neglect to tell is the door was open to his bedroom.
Yeah.
So we also lived with his sister. And as all this is going on, she's walking down the hallway, and I'm like on my knees, and he's got his ass bent over. Right. And I remember her looking in going, what is going on in here?
I just don't.
What is going on in here?
Don't ask.
James got a needle in his ass. Trying to get it out. And then I'm like, she's like, well, what?
She
said, why did you go down to the drugstore to get tweezers? I have like three or four pairs of them in my bathroom.
Like, he probably didn't want me
and
to.
And I'm like, oh, I didn't. I mean, I yeah.
Of course she's.
Did everybody just know he was juicing?
Oh, yes. You.
Oh, that would have been my first question.
You could tell.
Right. If I saw somebody pulling a needle out of my brother's butt cheek, I would go, why is there a needle in your butt?
Tell me you sat on it.
No, he was pretty well waterlogged for most of the cycles. And then afterward, he would kind of cut down a little bit for his competitions and stuff and be ripped and lose like 20, 30 pounds. I mean, it was like two different people.
Yeah.
I mean, he looked like this just bloated Hulk. And then when he would do his competitions,
right, all the muscle comes out.
He would go to the tanning bed and he would do all that crap and shave his body down. And I mean, he legitimately looked like, you know, a guy who was maybe going to win it.
Actually, the first guy that I ever knew that was really into bodybuilding, and I'm a kid at this time, which figures into the story. His name was John something. I can't remember his last name, but he was jacked. He was in ninth grade. I was friends with his younger brother, Kurt. All right. Kurt, not into bodybuilding, scrawny kid like I was. No big deal, whatever. And one of the kids that was, so our school was K through 8. We're in 6th grade. There's an 8th grader. And this particular 8th grader, very, very large dude, and he ran with a couple of the bullies, right? And he was always like, they're heavy. Nobody wanted to mess with this guy. And his nickname was Moose, all right? The problem with this is, his name was Scott. The only people that called him Moose were me, Kurt, and about three or four of our friends, okay? So lunch ends, the hallway gets filled up. And like anything, you know, you're young, you're trying to impress the bullies and all that. And they never really messed with us. We were never on the radar, but try to be cool. So he says, what's up to this one guy, Bill? Bill just kind of nods his head at him. What's up, Moose? Moose looks at my buddy, Kurt. He's like, what the F did you just call me? And it's one of those moments, I can see the blood drain out of his face. You know, like when Bugs Bunny got nervous, his ears were dropped to the back. It was that kind of moment. And I'm not going to sugarcoat this, but Moose commenced to whipping Kurt's ass in the middle of the hall. I mean, badly, okay? But, so that's one day. Well, the problem is, now every time Moose sees Kurt, who he'd never paid attention to before, he's going to beat Kurt's ass. And every day, man, basically after lunch, like, Kurt did not want to leave the table. We weren't going to be of any help. There's nothing you can do against this guy, right? So, he didn't beat his ass so much anymore, but it would be grab him by the collar and just slam into the locker.
Let's say shove him into something.
Yeah, you know, but this is every day, man. And again, this kid, as we perceived him at the time, was gigantic. Well, Kurt gets over this, tells his brother John, who's the guy who's into bodybuilding. And his brother was not a mean guy. He's actually a very nice guy, but you don't mess with someone's younger brother. And he's a big dude. And he's in ninth grade, so he's not sweating eighth graders, because that's how it works in school, right? So he's going to come to the school, and after school, he's going to grab Moose, and he's going to beat Moose's ass and send a message. We didn't know if he really would or not. Sure enough, school ends. There's his brother. He grabs this dude, pummels him in front of the bike racks, and says, you leave my brother alone. Don't mess with my little brother. That kind of thing, right? I mean, just on haymakers, has this guy on the ground. Kids are now screaming. He's bleeding out of his face. Everyone's like, oh, my God, right? You don't mess with my brother. He beat up the wrong kid.
Oh, no.
Oh, yeah. That wasn't Moose at all, dude. But we don't know that at first because he's on top of this guy straddling him, right? So we see him from the back. And, I mean, just you see his elbows come up, fist slams down on this guy. And this guy's screaming, you know, for mercy. Like, you leave my brother alone. You don't mess with him. So at the moment, we're like, yeah. That'll show Moose, man. And when we kind of turn the corner, Kurt's like, oh, my God, that's not him, man. This is an entirely different kid, just a bigger kid who's getting his ass whipped, man. Meanwhile, Moose sees what's going on. He kind of pieces it together, man, because Kurt's not pointing, you know, at actual Moose. Moose recognizes this guy, John, big dude. But so Moose did not mess with Kurt anymore after that. But someone else had to pay the price.
So he never caught the ass whipping.
He never caught the ass whipping.
He just was like, but statement it was made.
Right. I'm not going to mess with Kurt anymore. But, man, this poor kid just got the piss beat out of him. We're like, oh, no, man. That's not the right guy. And then John's one of those dudes, you know, kind of picks him up, trying to brush him off. I mean, the kid's bawling, you know what I mean? Blood everywhere. You all right, man? I'm sorry, dude. My bad. I'm really sorry, man. Really sorry. So, yeah, but it still worked.
Who screwed up and how did they screw it up? 206-803-ROCK.
Oh, yeah. It worked.
I mean, that's the funny thing, too.
It worked. I mean, he wasn't going to mess with them anymore, but it's like...
It kind of proved the point, too, that Moose wasn't as tough as he thought he was.
You aren't going to mess with Kurt's older brother. That's for sure, man. But damn, that kid took an ass whipping for nothing. Hello, Darren. Welcome to the men's room.
Hey, liquor and whores, bitches.
Liquor and whores.
All right, so I'll keep this short and sweet, man. I've been driving truck for 20 years, and one of the things you always run into is low cable wires or low telephone wires. I've ripped a few out. Everybody does it. It happens. You just move on. but a buddy of mine was going through a neighborhood in Tacoma. And he catches one of these wires. The only difference was the cable company didn't install it. The dude was stealing cable. And so he just hardwired it into his TV.
Oh, no.
Dude took... Oh, yeah. This truck took a TV out the side of this guy's house.
Oh, no.
Yeah, it folded the TV up through the drywall and out the siding and into the yard. The wire went up and over the fairing on the truck and caught the smokestack, you know, the exhaust stack, so he had to stop. But, yeah, it was pretty interesting, man. I saw the pictures of it. It was freaking hilarious.
Was the guy home when this happened?
I don't believe he was. No, unfortunately, it wasn't me. I wish it was my story, you know, but I don't believe he was. But he had some explaining to do later on because he got a phone call at work, from what I heard, and had to come explain why, you know, because my company couldn't get that truck out of there until we got the cable company there to clean up the mess.
Oh, man.
And, yeah, and so the driver, my buddy, he was stuck there for like an hour and a half. Yeah.
I wish the guy had been home watching TV, and, you know, TV suddenly just blows through the drywall.
Oh, God, yeah.
And all of a sudden the TV comes out of the side of the house, it would have been awesome. I know, it would have been fantastic.
Hey, do you, so I understand that, you know, you hit these wires and then you move on or whatever, but here's my question to you. Do you have to report it, or do you just ignore it?
So that depends entirely upon who's in the office. The very first time it happened to me, was up off of 85th Street in North Seattle there. And I was in a neighborhood night. Everybody does.
I hate 85th,
It's awful. So I caught this phone line, and I took it down, and I was a new driver, and I got all nervous. I called my dispatcher, and he goes, oh, those damn things are supposed to be 15 feet. He hung up the phone and ignored me. And I was like, oh, I guess that means I'm supposed to move on. Because I tried calling him back, and he didn't answer. And I'm like, okay, I guess that means I'm supposed to move on.
Look, there's a tree there's a tree in front of my property. I've contacted as many people as I possibly can.
The city's going to do nothing about it.
To get it trimmed back, because it's either...
It has heritage branches.
It's either an 18-wheeler semi or a big box truck coming through. Or, God forbid... You know those, I don't know what the hell's going on in the city. The buses that are just for the people who won't get on the bus because they work in the IT world.
Right, yeah.
The big white buses.
Yeah.
The Microsoft bus.
They take them over to campus.
Well, they take them through, if there's construction going on, they don't stay on the bus routes. They just go wherever the hell they want. So I'll come home. This is the second time in the last month where a huge-ass branch has fallen down and smacked into the car below it, or whatever the deal is. Just gets ripped off. And there's, of course, there's electrical wires everywhere through the tree. Like, they need to come and
they're not going to do it, man.
And trim the tree down. But I'm the one who's got to cut this crap up in my front yard, you know, with like a handsaw, because it's like 2.5, 3. The branch is big.
Yeah.
And to put it in the yard bag, man, I got to cut it into small sections, you know, and stick it in there. So by the time I'm just like, hey, this is driving me nuts.
That would piss me off too, man.
This is the second one. I'm like, I'm responsible for the fact that you won't come out here and cut the damn tree down so the trucks won't keep, you know.
I'll tell you from experience. The city ain't going to make a move on a tree that legitimately poses a problem.
Well, it's not like a sacred tree or anything. It's just amazing.
Doesn't matter. Still, just look, sacred tree or not, when it's at a 45-degree angle, like, it's going to fall. We don't care. Let it hit your house. Cool. Thank you. Thank you for that. That was awesome all summer. Mm-hmm. Your tree, I guarantee it, they're not going to do anything.
No.
Trees, they're just protected here. Like I said,
basically, the trucks just blow right through the tree thinking it's, you know, kind of more air than not.
Yeah.
And just huge-ass branches just get ripped off.
You want to borrow my chainsaw?
Man, if you
have... if the city caught you doing that.
Do you have a chainsaw?
I do, actually.
I need that.
Okay. It cuts through bone, too.
Because it just happened again. I'm like, you got to be kidding me. I just finally got the yard waste taken out because I didn't put my address on the bag.
Right.
Know, like, oh, no, surely you wouldn't do this yard work and throw away your yard waste where you dump your garbage. Like, who the hell else did you think it was going
to
be?
What house do you think this belongs to?
I mean, my God, people. I mean, do you really, like, okay, bill me for it. But guess what? You're the guys that I stuffed all that crap in there because the branches keep coming down from the tree that you won't cut down, and now you're charging me for it? You suck.
I'm telling you, man, it's a racket.
You suck.
Dude, when's the last time you've been to the dump?
The last time I went to the dump? I can't tell you that because it's I can tell you off the air.
That's what I'm saying. Like when I was moving the last time, like I went to one dump and they're like, you don't live in the right neighborhood. You can't leave it.
Really?
Like, okay. And then like, yeah. And then there was something.
You go north or south?
I went north. I was over by yours.
Okay, in Fremont.
And they were like, I can't dump it here. And I was like, why not? And they're like, you don't live in the, I'm like, I'm moving. Doesn't matter where I live. And they're, either way, I was already frustrated. And then another dump was like, you can't put that in here. It's like, where does it go? We're not sure. It's like, you're the dump. Where else do you want me to, like, am I supposed to just throw it in a dumpster? Like,
right. If you know where it doesn't go, then you know where it does go.
Right.
Yeah, so I'm like, this is the point of the dump.
Right. How do they make stuff that you can't throw away? Like the styrofoam coolers of the world and the peanuts and all that crap.
Can we stop using styrofoam peanuts?
The paint cans. All the just put it in like a paint plastic container. Anything else. There's got to be a better way to do this.
Well, the paint itself, not the vessel. But like the fluorescent light. So when we got the basement redone, we took out all these old-ass fluorescent lights where you felt like you're in a 1972 Pizza Hut right before a horror scene's about to happen. And we replaced it with like normal lights, right? So, but we have all these fluorescent bulbs. And right now, they're still just sitting in the garage. And I know there's a place we can take them and do all that. But let's be honest, I'm lazy. So for years, these things have been sitting in the garage. And I'm like, I know we need to get rid of these. Which is for whatever reason, we just never make the move to do it. Mm-hmm. But it's annoying. The same thing, you know, styrofoam peanuts and all that. And we got a note once, like, hey, don't put styrofoam in the trash. Like, that's fine, man. What do I do with it? And I don't want the styrofoam.
You know,
stuff that in this box.
You know, when I was a janitor, right? Now, granted, we had a loading dock. It was a massive building. And this is 2001, 2000. So, like, the rules weren't as strict. One of my favorite things was finding the those giant bulbs. You ever heard one shatter?
Oh,
the fluorescent
lights.
Like boom.
It's awesome.
It is.
I didn't know that they exploded, but I was working at Chi-Chi's. And it turns out, even if they don't work anymore, they still explode. We like three of them, whatever. Manager's like, hey, man, just throw these in the dump. Tall ass dumpsters. You flip the lid and kind of throw them over my head. These things landed in there, and I mean, boom. Mm-hmm. Scared the piss out of me. Glass came out. I go running into the manager. I'm like, dude, there's something in the dumpster. He's like, what are you talking about? I said, I threw the lights in and something exploded. He said, yeah, the lights did, dumbass. I'm like, I did not know this.
7 years ago, I bought a TV. It probably like, you know, Fred Meyer, wherever the hell I bought it. But in the box, the whole thing is surrounded by the styrofoam.
Yeah, those
that holds
big grips,
it.
Yeah.
Yeah, and then it goes all the way around the perimeter of the television. It's the inside of the box. So I put the box with that stuff on the corner. They left me a note and says, you can recycle the box. You can't recycle the styrofoam. Well, I wasn't trying to recycle. I was trying to throw it away.
Right.
You can't throw that away either.
That's what I'm saying.
Where does this go? Jimmy, dig a hole in the yard? Would that help you out? Right. I just stick it in the yard?
Yeah. Right. I'm all for recycling, compost.
Me too.
I think everybody in here actually...
Just tell me where to put it.
Right, but at the dump, I was like, just where do I take it then if you don't take it?
Somebody here says, for your styrofoam needs, there is a company called Ridwell that picks up items like that and recycles them.
All right.
That's good to know, man.
So let me get this straight. The company that produces those stuff, the companies that use it, know I can't recycle it. But they use it to save money. But then I can't. Then I got to spend my own money to get rid of it.
You can't put it in bubble wrap or something?
Jesus.
I have it on good authority that just a straight black hefty bag works just as nice.
I've never done that and tied it ultra tight so that they could not see
with
exactly
two paint cans in the bottom.
And a fluorescent bulb.
Dude, when I lived in Capitol Hill, that last place, the one corner like kind of like behind me, like you would have to be on that street for something specific. Put it this way. Part of that street is still brick.
Okay.
Right? So it's not traveled a lot. But the one main corner. I mean, there wasn't a day I didn't walk by there where it wasn't a couch, a chair, and paint cans.
Yeah.
I think people from all over the city was like, head up to the hill.
There's a place you can put it.
Yeah. Who screwed up and how did they screw it up? 206-803-ROCK.
Hello, Charlie. Welcome to the men's room.
How you guys doing?
Hola. Look at ours.
Well, what happened was, I was back I'm in my 50s now, but I was in my 20s, and I had a concrete company that was pretty successful, and I had a lot of hot rod trucks, and I live in a county called Kitsap County. It's nicknamed Kidnap County, and there's an adjacent city that's called Bremerton.
Yeah.
And I rolled a stop sign one night. Well, they arrested me.
Once again, bedroom colors, here are the 7 words you can't say on the radio. Sucker, mother, and please keep those words in mind when calling. Now back to the program.
All right, Charlie, please continue.
Sorry about that. And so I didn't complain because he didn't come, you know, he didn't give me no crap about, you know, my drinking. And so I go to jail, and, you know, I figure it was one of my stupid, you know, driving.
Oh, God!
Once again, bedroom colors. Here I mean, are the seven
we more. Just
and
went through this.
The radio.
I know you'd do it again.
Yeah. I think we give up.
Sucker.
Yes. Yeah.
And
next time, take your time with your words.
When calling. Now back to the program.
Like, we just went through this, man. We just did this. Same word.
Oh, boy.
I get the feeling he ends every sentence with and S.
And stuff.
I just, thanks for the education on this Kitsap County in Bremerton.
Right.
Return of Who's Fox Last coming up. You are listening to The Men's Room.
Therapy is known to be extremely helpful. But have you ever tried eavesdropping on someone else's problems? Listen to the new podcast, Say More with Dr. Sheila, starring Amy Poehler as the world-renowned self-proclaimed couples therapist.
You know, it's funny, as I was making the appointment to come today.
I'm sorry, I made the appointment.
I booked
the appointment.
Listen to Say More with Dr. Sheila on the free Odyssey app or wherever you get your podcasts.
Transit is better with an Orca card. Here's why. One, it's easy. Just tap and pay your way onto Metro and all other public transit around the Sound. Two, your tap shows us when and where you're riding the most, so Metro can serve you better. And three, Orca cards are for everyone. 18 and younger now ride free with a free youth Orca card. So what are you waiting for? Get an Orca card. Tap for transit and make your ride count today. Visit kingcounty.gov/tap for transit.
Let's face it, most people aren't making massive turkey feasts on the regular. And after 364 days of not thinking about it, it can be hard to get that bird just right. That's where Instacart, the holiday rescue app, comes in. From getting all the ingredients to prep a full seasonal spread to getting last-minute swaps in a turkey emergency, Instacart has everything a holiday host needs to save face and save dinner. And right now, if you download Instacart, you'll get free delivery on your first three orders and delivery in as fast as 1 hour. Offer valid for a limited time. $10 minimum per order. Additional terms apply.
Looking to give the gift of pleasure? Add a little high heat to keep the desire burning. Or maybe you just need a little self-care. Come to Lovers for the best lingerie and toys to keep things hot this holiday. Save 20% on your purchase with Lovers Afterglow Rewards. Just mention LOVE20 at one of our 18 Western Washington locations. Offer valid with free Lovers Afterglow Rewards membership until November 30th. Some exclusions apply.
What's up? It's your boy, the Ted Smith from the Men's Room. And did you know I have a podcast? Well, I do. The Podcast. New episodes uploaded every Wednesday on the Odyssey app.
The debauchery rolls on. You're listening to the Men's Room with Miles and Thrill. 99.9 KISW.
Live day goes to prom night. We're doing it at night this year, bitches. And
that's
everything
right.
Is completely live, from the host, the sound effects, the voice actors doing all the commercials, all the Foley artists making the sound effects for us, the barbershop quartet.
Yeah.
Of course, every prom needs a live band. We got a hell of a house band. It's like the all-star band of Seattle.
Essentially.
Coming together to play some nice prom music for us as live day heads to prom night. November 17th, that is a Friday night at Snoqualmie Casino. The doors open at 6. BJ and Migs go on at 7. Mm-hmm. When we came on, we'll come on after that and do a little back-to-back. So this year, instead of a full day, it's going to be a full night of fun. So
what time do we go on? 9:30.
I'm assuming 9:30, somewhere in there.
9 o'clock.
Yeah, we're doing a night show again, like we were on the bus.
Hey, there you go.
Back in the day, way back when. So yeah, it's going to be a great night. And to be honest with you, we are stoked to do it this way, just simply because you get to see both shows back to back, and you don't have 4 hours to wait in between.
In between, right?
It's Friday night, man. So it's going to be action packed. Boom, boom, boom. Everything's going to be live, and it's a totally different way of doing a live day. But we're doing it a prom night style this year, Snoqualmie Casino. All the ticket information and details at KISW.com. You have to be 21 years of age or older. We're going to have a good night at Snoqualmie, which is one of the nicest casinos in the area. So it's going to be a good time. All right. Let's see, do we have time for a few emails from the men's room at KISW.com?
You've got mail. You've got mail.
We'll start with one from our question today. Who screwed up and how did they? Boo bitches, I forgot I wasn't 15 anymore. Decided to jump out of the bed of a pickup truck at 32 years old.
Oh, God.
I hope it wasn't moving. Completely ruptured my ACL, tore up my meniscus and my knee 8 years later. still hurts when the weather changes.
I can believe that, man.
That's unfortunate. All right, let's see.
I'm just like, why would you do that?
Because, you know, we're guys. We do stupid things. And at 32, I feel like you're still like, I still got it in me, right? Mm-hmm. Oh. That's about the age where I started going, okay, some physical realities are starting to take hold here.
I bet most people couldn't jump out of a moving golf cart and not fall over.
No.
Much
no.
less
that's a dumb truck. That's a dumb idea. I've seen that before.
Oh. I mean, I haven't played golf in years, and I've seen it.
Yeah.
It's a classic drunk move on the golf course.
Classic drunk move. Yes.
It is. So, yeah, it is right out.
Uh-huh. Ola Bitch is on to the birthday request. My son's name is Stomy. Maybe it's Stormy, but I think it's Stomy. And he turns 12 years old today. Loves listening to you guys. Could he get a birthday shout-out with a fish sandwich and a Leroy Jenkins? They also requested the Dirty Germans, but we do not do Dirty Germans unless you are 18 years of age.
Yeah, we are legal.
Thanks, guys. That's from the lovely Clarissa.
Do you want to get a fish sandwich?
Let's do this. Leroy Jenkins!
Gentlemen, today is my nephew Joseph's 18th birthday. He is an amazing, upbeat kid. He has been fighting, osteosarcoma, cancer.
Not nice.
Since he was 13. So could he get a fart montage? Miles giving him an inspirational thought about being a man now that he's an adult. And the Dirty Germans talking about the joys of making it to adulthood and what he can expect from the Germans today. Happy birthday, Joseph. That from Uncle Boo Boo.
Mike, that's what it sounded like when I heard that chick I was talking about earlier in the bathroom.
Yeah. Joseph, remember as an adult that timing is everything. One time I was at a conference and the chairman introduced the guest speaker as a former illegal alien. Well, I jumped up from my chair and I yelled, "What's the matter? No jobs on Mars?" And no one laughed, and I was very embarrassed.
You okay, man?
Who is that?
Yeah, now that you're 18 years old, the Dirty Germans can do the things to you that we've been thinking about for so long. But no lubricant.
Yeah, so you know, also we could take you out to one of some clubs and see some breast.
Yeah.
The best breast.
Yeah.
Take you to the breast western.
Nice.
All the guys, I want to send a birthday shout out to my best friend Alex. He is moving from Seattle to Las Vegas next week.
Oh.
And we're all going to miss him. He loves your show, listens every day, but the birthday shout out part is by far his least favorite segment. He gets annoyed with people always requesting the same sound bites. So for his birthday, Alex would like a nice moment of silence. Thanks, guys. Love the show. That from Noah.
I'm a little bit country. I'm a little bit rock and roll.
God, he pisses me off the way he says
Well, that's
that.
Where you're going. You're going to Vegas. You get to see Donnie and Marie.
Yeah. That is a good point, man.
Yeah, man. I mean, Barry Manilow is also probably doing a residency. Yeah. That's right. It's not just every sporting event on the planet anymore. They got more stuff.
Should I? I should try to sneak in one of those shows.
Barry?
I'm a little bit country.
You're going to go just to heckle Donnie Marie.
Well, it's like, hey, you know what? Maybe I'm in the wrong. Watch F1, go to cool bars, watch NFL football, or go see Donnie and Marie.
You could scream lines from, what was the documentary from Trey Parker and Matt Stone?
Book of Mormon.
Yeah, Book of Mormon. You could throw that on. Guys, today is my husband's 35th birthday.
Are they in the Book of Mormon?
No, but
they're Mormon.
Oh.
They're like the most famous Mormons I can think of.
Yeah. Mormon family. Like, they were the ones.
No kidding.
Yeah.
Can you think of a more famous Mormon?
Yep. He ran for president.
Really?
Mitt Romney.
Oh, there's also Joseph Smith.
One
of your relatives. You know, from way back in the day. The guy that about the UFOs and the aliens and stuff.
That's, you know what? Yeah.
That's your guy.
Well, I'm related to most of the Smiths.
But not him.
Not him.
Like with the Montgomery for the Detroit Lions, rips on off. Running back?
Yeah,
I'm like, that's my family.
It's my cousin. Yeah. Go fam.
Exactly. He's just darker skin than I am.
Yeah. I was going to say, because there's a lot of Smiths, white and black. But if it's a black dude in the NFL, I'm going to say, yeah, man, it's my cousin.
Sure.
Yeah. Every time, yeah.
Wait, three generations back.
Yeah, I showed him how to catch a football.
I remember those days.
Right? Over at Grandma Smith's? Oh, God, I love to see that kid doing well. Right, hands out.
See what Would you say that to Steve Smith Jr.?
No, because his dad scares me.
I know.
That is the dad.
That's what I'm saying. His dad scares me, so I wouldn't say it to Junior.
Guys, today is my husband's 35th birthday. He would love all the farts. Happy birthday, Justin. Thank you, guys. That from Kelly.
Oh, it's so wet.
I know.
It's just so wet, man.
Oh, Mitchell. Today is my son Skyler's birthday, 21 years old. We've been listening to your show for years, and now he's old enough to meet you guys. So, could he get some shotgun blasts, a big old bong rip, and let's see here. And the wet, what? Oh, a wet one. Keep it light, bitches. That from Dad in Federal Way. Yeah. Afternoon, bitches. Longtime loyal listener, avid player of the Men's Room home board game.
Excellent.
The extension packs keep the game fun and exciting. I own the Ted Nugent Slither Sleuth Edition, or section.
Yeah.
Miles, my lost hole-in-one certificate edition. Steve, the throw of my heel and slap my my bass board.
Yes, my bass.
Bass board add-ons. I even own the limited edition Ben the Psychopath and the Dirty Wobbin deck. Looking forward to getting the extended Mike Hawk package.
That should be happening soon. The holidays are coming up.
Anyway, my nephew Alex turns 21 today. I was wondering if the Germans can tell him what they're going to do to him at the casino tonight. And words of wisdom from Miles. Thanks for all the laughs over the years. That from Rich E. in Ole.
Yeah, now that you're 21 years old, I'm going to do to you, which I've always wanted to, which is sodomize you in the casino bathroom.
Yeah, the other funny thing is on your birthday, everybody likes sex. Some people call it the F word. I can guarantee you, she will feel the F word tonight as the casino never loses.
Yeah.
But good luck.
21 years old. An important thing to know there, Alex, is always have a designated driver. For sure. So here's some advice on that. We were taught as kids to never, ever get in a stranger's car for any reason or meet strangers on the internet. Now, we literally summon strangers from the internet and get in their cars.
That is true.
You need to do that.
I did it this morning.
All right, guys, here you go. Happy, happy, happy birthday. Happy, happy, happy birthday. Happy, happy, happy birthday to you.
BG.
Yaws of Dirty Germans, brought to you by Men's Room Original Sausage. Available through Uli's World Famous Sausage, mensroomlive.com, and other fine retailers. Schweinefleisch.
Thank you, Robin. Text came in, will there be no BJ and Migs in your show during the day than on live day? No, it's live day goes to prom night, you see.
Correct.
So instead of being during the day, we are doing the show at night.
Mm-hmm.
The doors open at 6 o'clock at Snoqualmie Casino. I believe BJ and Migs will go on around 7. And then we will come on after them and go right back to back on the show.
So one of our guaranteed future repeats, guaranteed to be heard that day.
That's right. That's right. Let's see here. From yesterday, we were talking food all day long. Man, I was starving when I got
By the way, quick shout out to Suzanne at the 884. You know what you did, and we appreciate it.
Yes.
So good.
I'm still burping it up.
I have to poop again. Seriously, I had to poop after eating no food.
Did you?
Almost, I told Miles, I'm like, I got to make room for the sandwich. And then about 20 minutes ago, I'm like, dude, I think I got to poop again.
Right.
Like, I'm almost in a food coma.
Guys, Bacholas, I'm dying listening to today's show. You guys are talking about all this delicious food while I'm sitting here at home fasting and doing my colonoscopy prep. It's pretty crappy, if you ask me. Anyway, I'm looking forward to eating whatever I want tomorrow afternoon. Hopefully, we've got there right now and you've been able to eat. Thanks, guys. That from Commissioner Gordon of the Men's Room Army. I am getting set for that, and I've been reading prep stuff again. I went over to the Walgreens, showed up to pick up my stuff, and they said, oh, yeah, you have to come here first and then tell us you want it and then come back and get it later. And I said, well, didn't the doctor call it in? And they said, yeah. They said, no, we don't do it that way. You're going to have to come in, and then you got to come back. So I'm going to eventually
What's the
go
point of the doctor calling it in if it doesn't mean anything to
I have no idea. Either way, similar situation. on my colonoscopy is like at 12:30 on Friday.
Mm-hmm.
I have to start fasting at 9 o'clock on Thursday.
A.M.
Damn. All right. I cannot eat anything. It's all clear. Everything from then. It's just then I have to take the pills at noon. And then I have to start drinking the drink at 5.
What do the pills do? I know what the drink does.
I don't know. That's the first time I've ever done this.
Really?
Part of the procedure. Yeah.
Just give them some random pills.
Depends on the color, dude.
Right. And then
wake up in the Matrix, bro.
Yeah. No alcohol. I don't think I can have any cigarettes. Try to go to bed like a normal human being.
Can't smoke a cig?
Then I got to wake up at 5:30 in the morning, right? And drink the other half of the gallon.
Ooh.
And then I know how this works because VD was there the last time. He was installing my faucet in my kitchen because he's capable of doing
that.
Right,
he's that guy.
And he can, and I can. And I swear to God, I was trying to bend over to help him. And every 5 minutes, I ran into the bathroom. And it was just like, it didn't stop. I mean,
he told me. I came into work that Monday, and I'm like, hey, did you put in my miles a sink? He's like, yeah. I'm like, did Miles help you out? He's like, he tried. He just said, look, man, seriously. He just kept running out of the room because he had to poop.
God,
like,
so
damn.
So I think you could, yeah. I was like, you can't eat, but I think you could still smoke a cig up until, like, before you go to bed.
Well, trust me, Ted. The one thing I've been thinking about is, what do I want to eat Friday afternoon when I wake up?
Yeah, man.
I mean, because I'm going to be starving. Like, I'm here.
Well, somebody here says you should not eat anything just after the colonoscopy. You have to take it easy on your stomach. No big greasy burgers.
Come on, man. Don't give me more bad news. Why? I was thinking about going to Dick's.
Why?
Because I'm up on Capitol Hill getting
I don't know, man, because you've had all that stuff in there. They've been looking in there. Like, I'm just not shocked if the doctor was like, hey, give it a couple days before you eat something greasy.
I mean, hey, you can roll the dice, bro. There's a reason they give the advice. Doesn't mean you have to take it. You know, they recommend that you don't drink bleach. It doesn't mean you can't, but you'll find out why they say don't.
Right.
That's or get a greasy burger and let us know.
Yeah, years ago, I was on like this meditation retreat, blah, 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 special little diet. So after the long week, right, it was tough. So it's like Sunday morning, and I'm just eating like eggs, but with like salt on them, like so good. The guy who runs it goes, by the way, if you want it to really work, you can't have any of that stuff you couldn't have for like another, 60 days.
60?
But he's my friend, so I just went, F you. He goes, you don't have to do it. I said, well, you know me. Right, like, right. I'm going to do it now, so just F off.
Leave me alone. I'm starving.
Coming up, we will drink a toast with a shot of the day, but first.
Now, the men's room wants to know.
Hey, time for Who Sucks Less. Stephen Thrill-Hill, you bring us three stories from the news each and every week. They all suck. It's up to us to determine, out of the three stories, which one sucks the least. Now, if you happen to follow KISW on Facebook or Twitter, the debate is already underway on Who Sucks Less.
Yes, indeed. Before we get there, Miles, just so you know, somebody here says, my doctor said I could eat right after the colonoscopy. I bought myself a bacon cheeseburger on the way home. No problem with my stomach.
All right.
God, I hope you're right.
Conflicting reports.
Well, I'm going to ask.
He could be lying, and he's just setting Miles up to poop himself.
I'm going to ask when I wake up, like, hey, is this cool?
Gonna
I'm starving, dude. And you're beeping up in the no-go hole.
Sure, ask when you're all drugged up. That's a great time to retain information.
Hey, man, being all drugged up to me is pretty easy to deal with.
Right,
cool. It's kind of like, I can handle this.
Yeah. All right, today we have three stories, as always. We have a...
you just casting money.
Exactly.
Not a dog walker.
Sober people might have a hard time with this.
Not a dog walker, but a woman who is, in fact, walking her own dog. We have a Burger King manager, and then we have an unusual stalker. But let's start in Florida, where a woman is facing a felony charge after shoving a bag of dog poop into the face of an elderly neighbor. 28-year-old Kaylee Robertson, she was arrested Sunday morning after a confrontation at the mobile home park where she and the 76-year-old victim live. Now, they live in separate residences, they're neighbors. Now, according to the complaint charging Robertson, she became upset with Danielle Powell, who would, quote, always speak with her while she walked her dog. That's it. Speak with her. We do not know if there was a conflict. It just says she'd always speak to her. Well, Robertson took an unsecured bag of dog feces and pushed it into Powell's face, leaving feces smeared on his face and the bag on the ground. Now, the dog waste bag, as they say, matched those in the defendant's possession. Now, she ultimately admitted to smearing the dog poop into the woman's face. This is where it gets annoying. She was released from jail. She pleaded not guilty to third-degree felony. You just said you admitted to doing it. So they're like, well, we're going to charge you with what you did. Well, I'm going to say not guilty. Then why'd you say you did? Either way. So, smearing dog poop in another woman's face, we don't know why.
Right, okay, we don't know why.
Just said every time she walks her dog, the neighbor would speak to her. Maybe her neighbor was always harassing her. Don't know. But literally, it was just always speaks to her. Now we go to South Carolina, where an assistant manager at a Burger King is facing up to 20 years in prison for serving French fries out of the garbage. A couple of Sundays ago, cops responded to a call at a Burger King in Union, South Carolina. When they got there, two customers were screaming at a 39-year-old worker named Jamie Major. And initially, they got arrested for disorderly conduct, but then the cops got the full story, turned around, and arrested Jamie instead. It turned out the two women had seen Jamie take old fries out of the trash, dump them in a container, and then put fresh fries on top. Now, it's not clear if the fries were for them or someone else. It's just what they witnessed. Now, cops arrested Jamie for malicious tampering with food, which is a felony. And if a judge throws the book at her, she could get up to 20 years in prison. Burger King, as you'd expect, they fired her and released the statement, you know, we don't normally condone.
Again, no reason why. She just did it.
Just did it. So they don't know if it's a practice you always did. Have more inventory. Don't know. And now, this is the weird one. So you've probably heard the old gag where people would throw tomatoes at bad performers. This is weird. A 65-year-old man in New Hampshire, he's named Michael Arnold. He's been arrested for stalking a woman for 4 years. But he wasn't just following her around. He would also fly a small propeller plane over her house in New York and throw tomatoes on her roof from above. He sometimes did these flybys 3 times in a week, and she could definitely hear it. She said he'd fly so close that the doors and windows would rattle. Now, the woman says she made repeated complaints, but she couldn't get the authorities to take her seriously, even when her neighbors corroborated the claims about the low-flying plane and the tomatoes that the pilot was throwing at her house. And even when the neighbors did that, she still could not get the police to work with the FAA. Now, for the record, even though the plane was Michael's, he denied that he was the one flying it, but he refused to reveal who the pilot was, because it was him. He told the news, quote, "I might be able to, but I don't want to throw anybody under the bus. If they don't want to get involved, I can't get them involved." Again, because it's him. Now, Michael never had a relationship with the victim. It started when he was a customer that would show up at her cafe and just be creepy. At one point, he emailed her unsolicited, quote, "inappropriate photos." That would be his penis. Now, she warned him to cool it. That's when he started stalking her and threatening her from the ground, the air, and on social media. She already has an order of protection against them. So now he's facing an additional 8 counts of misdemeanor criminal contempt as 1 felony count. So those are your 3 stories. You're the woman who, and we do not know why she smeared dog poop in her neighbor's face, but she did. Because they always chat, I guess. The Burger King manager serving fries out of the trash. And finally, the airborne stalker who throws tomatoes.
I mean, I think it's pretty easy. I think the worst guy is the stalker, just because you're just harassing that woman.
Yeah.
And you live in New Hampshire. Having rotten tomatoes on top of your roof, some type of wildlife is going to show up.
For sure.
Then I'd say the woman in Florida sucks the second most.
Dog turd lady.
Yeah. I want to know what the interaction is. Maybe she's just bat-ass crazy.
Might be.
But obviously. I mean, the Burger King manager, like, look, that's gross, but compared to those other two, I'm like, I don't know. Like, I've eaten food off the floor. I've eaten food out of a trash can.
Okay. I know for a fact you've eaten trash
can.
I know one thing.
I'm like, ah. I know one thing for a fact from being, and I know they changed the recipes from working at BKU.
Oh, Lord.
But you don't go there for the fries.
That's very true.
The fries are just.
Their fries are a lot better.
I'm an
now.
Onion ring guy. Oh, if they changed them, that's one thing. But
Yeah, it was like a massive deal.
So what are they, skin on, or are they...
They just have like a crispier kind of edge around them.
Yeah, okay.
So
they can still stay warm even if they've been in the trash can for
Even in the trash can, Miles.
You put them under the heat lamp.
I'm going to agree with you then.
I'll tell you what. This week, I'll get you some trash fries.
See if you can tell. One of these packs of fries was in the trash can.
Miles, throw Mike. Who do you think got the trash fries?
Debate continues on Who Sucks Less if you follow KISW on Facebook and on Twitter.
There. They're all from the trash.
Show of the Day's coming up. You are listening to The Men's Room.
I'm Snoop Dogg, and I'm giving up smoke. I know what you're thinking. Snoop, smoke is kind of your whole thing. But I'm done with it. I'm done with the coughing and my clothes smelling all funky. I'm going smokeless. Solo Stove Fixed Fire. They took out the smoke. Now you can have a nice blaze without any clouds ruining your day. Go smokeless. Go to solostove.com. Tell them Big Snoop Dogg sent you.
Are you dealing with a personal injury? Don't go it alone. Turn to the experienced team at Phillips Law Firm. Their attorneys have helped thousands of clients get the compensation they deserve. Call Phillips Law Firm now. Call 1-800-JUSTICE or visit justiceforyou.com.
Getting older means a world of change, but some things still stay the same, like being at risk for type 1 diabetes, because type 1 can happen at any age. So screen it like you mean it. If just one person in your family has type 1, you're up to 15 times more likely to get it too. And 50% of type 1 diagnoses happen after the age of 18. So screen it like you mean it. Type 1 diabetes starts long before you need insulin, and one blood test could help you spot it early and lower the risk of serious complications like diabetic ketoacidosis, known as DKA. So don't get caught by surprise. Screen it like you mean it, because getting answers now can help you get prepared. The more you know, the more you can do. So don't wait. Talk to a doctor about how to get screened. Tap now or visit screenfortype1.com to learn more. Again, that's screenfortype1.com. And screen it like you mean it.
Transit is better with an Orca card. Here's why. One, it's easy. Just tap and pay your way onto Metro and all other public transit around the Sound. Two, your tap shows us when and where you're riding the most, so Metro can serve you better. And three, Orca cards are for everyone. 18 and younger now ride free with a free youth Orca card. So what are you waiting for? Get an Orca card, tap for transit, and make your ride count today. Visit kingcounty.gov/tap for transit.
99.9 KISW. The shenanigans continue. This is the Men's Room with Miles and Thrill.
All right, Dakota here in just minutes. We'll drink and toast for the shout of the day. And we do have your headlines on the way at 5:50. But first, quick check-in with Mike Hawk and some of the stories and headlines he is not working on.
Thank you, Miles. There's a new food trend going viral. Potato chip salad.
Tell me more.
It's potato chips in a salad, Ted.
Like a regular lettuce salad?
My guess is it's going to be like a potato salad, just made with potato chips instead.
Okay. Oh, yeah, if it just gets soggy.
Yeah.
You know, with your typical other ingredients, it gets soggy, then I don't know anyone who's cool with wet potato chips.
I agree. At that point, it just becomes a
wet potato, but for whatever, you're like, I am not going to eat that.
It just becomes an overly thin scalloped potato.
Yeah, there you go.
You know what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
Or maybe, I don't know.
I mean,
Ted, you're asking me questions about something I'm not working on, man.
Thank you. Sorry. So I was about to scold you. Like, God forbid you look up a story there, Mike.
Damn. You got a pepper on there.
I know where you live.
Not for much longer. A new study is claiming that coin tosses are...
What are you shooting me?
A new study is claiming that coin tosses are not as random as people think, as the coin landed on the same side 51% of the time.
And it was tails.
Was it tails?
I don't know. I'm guessing. I'm a tails never fails guy.
Well, you know what?
Okay.
That might be right. Because I think that there's a little bit more mass on the head side, so it pulls it down a little bit more.
That was just the thing I learned in high school. It's always like, do we go heads, do we go tails? It was just like, hey, tails never fails. Call it every time.
And it rhymes.
And it rhymes.
And I like how that debunks the coin toss as if it's now so skewed 51%.
Okay.
Whatever.
Sorry. Yep. Whatever, dude. Good job.
I'm sure there'll be a protest.
A new study found the best and worst cities to drive in.
Best and worst cities to drive in.
Yeah.
I would say the worst city, if you were not from there, in my experience, was Boston.
Okay.
You can be in a residential street, you're doing 90 miles an hour. There's a traffic circle in the middle. And I mean, like, they're used to it, man.
Sure.
So they're not bad drivers. They're very good drivers, but it's almost like you have to take a defensive driving course to get your license in Boston.
Gotcha.
Right, because the streets are so tiny, and sure. It's just set up for horses and stuff, and then those people just fly up and down the street.
They know what they're doing. You don't. You don't want to. Like, don't rent a car in Boston and drive around. You're going to hate it.
Is it based on, like, traffic, or?
I don't know, Ted. I just know the results.
I'm sure Seattle's in there. We're just geographically challenged based on the layout of the
water.
City.
Yeah,
I know that Seattle is in the bottom 10 for sure as far as the worst cities, but the best cities, Corpus Christi is in at number one.
Okay.
Don't you have to drive over a giant bridge to get out there?
I don't know, man.
Yeah, but you can do it easily, too.
Raleigh and then Boise. That's your top three, your best cities to drive in.
Sure.
Raleigh, I'm like, okay, I can fathom that. Like, I've been to Boise on a game day. They ain't that many people.
That
might factor in.
All right, well then... I don't know. Can I add Kalispell, Montana?
Right.
I moved pretty freely through that city.
I don't know if that's one of the big 182.
Yeah.
The bottom three are Detroit, San Francisco, and then the worst is Oakland.
Damn, San Francisco to Oakland.
I mean, I'll tell you what. Like, San Francisco, I remember just taking, like, Ubers or cabs. Like, San Francisco, I like that city. It is just a pain to get around.
Yeah.
We took an Uber to the airport there a couple months ago, and it sucked. They had no other way to put it, man. Their traffic is bad.
But I'll tell you this. Last time I went, all I took was the BART.
Yeah, me too.
Yeah, I was think like, that'd be the way to go.
I was like, screw it. Like, I'll just take the BART everywhere.
I did like doing the cable car within town.
Yeah,
it's actually pretty affordable, and you can get.
There's a few of them, though.
Yeah, are there?
Yeah, because there's
one that goes over top of the hill.
Right, that's right. The main one that everybody wants to see. But there's some that branch out to the sides too. Because I took it from like the wharf over to like the baseball stadium.
I like the one that goes over the hill, so that I don't have to walk up that hill.
Yeah,
seriously, man. I'm like, we're gonna get in the cable car.
That hill sucks.
Yeah, it really does.
There's a handful of things that we try to do our best when it comes to life and just try to go through one day without screwing something up. However, there's a lot of different times when we just...
Every day.
We can't help but just awkwardly screw things up. And we all do it. And there's an entire list.
The Men's Room Top 10. The Men's Room Top 10.
10 hilarious things everyone is secretly guilty of doing. Now, I don't know if this person was trying to do this. The whole stumbling and turning it into a funny dance thing. But just yesterday, while poisoning myself one delectable puff at a time, I witnessed a guy go down like a sack of potatoes in the crosswalk.
Oh, no.
Lucky for him, there were people more concerned than me that ran to his aid to keep him from getting run over. He was okay, except for the blood cascading down the side of his face. Oh. What are you gonna do? Poor bastard.
Here's the thing.
He's not kidding.
That is a true story.
You guys saw it too?
No, we went down to smoke and he was in the corner.
I opened the door and asked him if he was okay. He was bleeding from his head.
Here's the thing. And BD's like, yeah, he just did a face plant in the middle of the street.
He
said, I feel like a terrible person because I didn't make a move, even though traffic was coming. Other people were picking the guy up when we got there.
It's also a very bad place to fall based on the fact that anyone coming up the hill can't see the flat and where he was located. So it could have been much worse.
The one thing I did enjoy about the entire thing, so we're kind of he was actually going to the, there's a medical facility within this building.
Yep.
So his wife was taking him there. Again, inside of his face busted open, right? So he's bleeding. So based on how our lobby is, you guys know where those big stairs are in the lobby?
Yep.
There's a group of probably 30 people, prospective tenants, coming down the stairs, getting a tour of the building.
Oh, no.
And this dude walks in with his face bleeding, and I'm like, I don't think they're getting that lease signed, bro. Oh,
damn. Hilarious things that everyone is secretly guilty of doing. We all do all of these things, or at least to some capacity there. You guys ever been driving, and then you're looking up directions to a place, or maybe you're in an unfamiliar area? Then you got to turn the radio down so they can see better.
Yeah, I don't know why. For some reason, you just want complete concentration.
You do.
It's the truth. It doesn't matter, but yeah, you do it every time.
But for what reason, it does matter because those loud noises. It does
somehow.
Yeah,
because everyone does. I mean, turn down the radio because I'm trying to find something. Like, okay.
I will admit I've seen this one on lists like this before, but I've never been guilty of it. Using the bathroom at a friend's house and then peeking at their medicine cabinet.
I've never done that.
In my younger days, I would, but keep in mind, in my younger days, I knew if there's anything, quote unquote, medical in there, it was something I wanted. Now, like, you're private with me, man. I don't care, and I don't want to know. Plus, the older you get, like, the medication, it's like, man, I probably need that.
Yeah, also, the older you get, the more you realize the way they do bathrooms anymore, there's no medicine cabinets. You got to get in the drawers and stuff. That's what I'm going through.
No kidding.
I just leave my scripts on my bathroom counter.
Why not?
Well, but also, it's like,
let's go over to Chance.
It's like, hey, he takes something so he doesn't get gout, and looks like he has high blood pressure. Like, there's nothing to steal.
Right. The stuff you want to hide is, like, herpacil.
What
right?
is this, tetracycline?
You guys ever been to a birthday party of somebody that you didn't know, and then they go in on that birthday song, and there comes that dreaded moment when you're singing along with the birthday song, and happy birthday.
I normally know the person's birthday that I'm going to.
Oh, no. I've done that.
Well, I normally
somebody just says, come over, and then you're singing. Yeah. You just kind of, and also, there's a way, if enough people are there, seems like you're singing with them, but they're always singing the first note.
Right.
Yeah. Right? So, like, happy birthday, dear Betty. You do that first, like, B-E. It's like, Betty.
You do that at restaurants with the table beside you when someone celebrates.
Oh, yeah.
I'll join in. It's kind of like dropping the N-bomb on a song when you're singing it. You know, you just kind of let that verse go and then move on.
You can't sing that part, but you can sing the rest
singing
of the song.
Singing the birthday song to someone you don't know is like singing a song with the N-word in it.
Well, you just
Miles Montgomery.
You just have to self- you just have to self-edit, that's all.
There's the promo.
That's what I was going to do.
All right, I'll say it.
Okay.
I don't think that's your name.
Oh, my goodness gracious.
Oh, that's pretty good.
Oh, God. Hilarious things that everyone is secretly guilty of doing. Oh, geez. Ignoring an email for weeks and then writing back saying, somehow this ended up in my spam folder.
Oh, hell yeah. Yeah, yeah, yeah.
That's why they quit sending you emails.
I will sorry. A.E. Dave. I know goddamn well you saw that email. It's not going to spam. I'm like, you might be right, but you can't prove it. So I'm going to stick with my story that it went to spam.
Oh, look,
and that's why I didn't respond to your request for something I didn't feel like doing.
Our internet service here will say you have messages that are on hold because they've been blocked.
Yeah.
And then you open those messages and you realize they're from our company.
They're from the company.
I know.
So
they don't censor anything other than things from our own company.
You blocked yourself.
Right.
Is this that important?
I got to say I'm guilty of this one. Eating a family-sized bag of chips by yourself.
Family size, no.
There's been many a time where I might have been just saddled up with a video game or a really good TV show. And
I feel like people in video games, I kind of get it.
Yeah.
It's not that you can't move, but you're not going to because you need to be present, right?
Sure.
So I kind of understand that situation.
I've definitely eaten about a whole bag of chips, but thrills are like family size seems a little
bigger. That's a mission, no doubt.
Yeah.
That's a mission.
I mean, if it's Ruffles, cheddar, and sour cream, yeah.
Right. I could, but I refuse to.
Nobody in here would do this, but lying to the doctor when they ask about your alcohol consumption.
I was telling the truth, and then they think I'm lying. But their idea of what heavy drinking is, and yes, they're in the medical profession, I just disagree. You know, I'm sorry, man. They're like, well, if you consume more than this many a week. And I'm like, a week, brother? I drink that a night. You know, like, seriously, man. Right. And they give you the look, and I'm like, okay, maybe I have a problem, but I tend to be honest with doctors just because I want them to know what's going on with me because they're going to do stuff to me and maybe they can say, okay, this is a result of
right
all of your drugs and booze, you dumbass.
Hilarious things everyone is secretly guilty of doing. If you ever been cooking something at home, like a frozen pizza, all right, set the oven to 375, put it in there for 10, 15 minutes, all right, okay. Throws the box away. 375. Damn it, how long did I need to put that in there for?
Go back, find the box.
Get out of the garbage can.
I do that all the time to this day.
I mean, even
as something as simple, you're just cooking it on the stovetop, and yep. Right? It's just like I have to remind myself, like, don't throw the packaging out.
Mm-hmm. And it's the same stuff, too. It's not like it's your first time cooking this pasta.
Yeah.
It's the same brand. You do it the same way every time.
Or 17
but you won't
minutes.
Commit it to memory.
Nope.
Because you have the box.
But yep.
I've done that within the last 3 or 4 days.
Yep.
That's what I was going to say. I did it Sunday. And then it's also weird because, like, I don't do it with eggs. But if they put directions on an egg carton, would I keep doing it?
Yes.
Yeah. That's
let's see here. Have you ever done this one? You sneeze, maybe, and someone says, bless you. And then you say something stupid like, you too. Hey, yeah. Man, happy birthday. Sure. You too.
Yeah.
Damn it.
Or are they talking like a telemarketer or someone didn't call customer service? And like, you've been on the
love
phone
you.
With them. Yeah, dude. It's like, all right, love you. Like, Jesus. My
and
bad.
When it's sneezing, become the work of the devil. Like, you need to be blessed.
Because they thought you were losing a demon.
Yeah.
That's what they thought sneezing was.
It literally
you
came
were,
from
you're
back
blowing back evil out of your out right. of your.
What about when you fart?
Body. That's different. You're just being nasty.
What do you say then?
I'm going to start saying bless you when people fart.
Exactly. I mean,
hey, man, bless you.
You want to talk about blowing out a demon.
But then the number one hilarious thing that everyone is secretly guilty of doing whenever you walk up to that person that you know, but you can't put your finger on their name. Hey, buddy.
I do that. So
what's
my wife
up, man?
Knows this about me. And anytime we have to do a school function, which apparently this school is like every other week. Look, I've known a lot of people like 6, 7 years, whatever it is. And my wife stops me before we go in the door. Here are the names. This is who they are married to. Still means nothing to me. And then she goes, they are the parents of. And I go, okay.
Gotcha.
So, but then when we walk in there, she will quietly whisper in my ear and point to the different people. That. But she knows how I am. I just don't remember things. We were at Tony V's. Tony came. This is for Castle's 20th all right. anniversary.
Yeah.
And Tony comes and finds me. He goes, hey, man, would you want to go up on stage? Castle's looking for you. Just help him do the initial stage announcement.
All right.
You're going to introduce a band. The band's name is blank. I go, cool. When do you need me? He goes, right now. I go, no problem. I start to walk off. My wife grabs my arm and goes, what's the name of the band? I say, I do not know. She's like, geez, I know you. So she repeated it. Then I had to repeat it to myself.
until I made it on stage.
I always try to help people out when I bring them into a situation where I don't know if they're not exactly sure on the names. I also don't ever ask. I will walk up into somebody and say, Steve, you remember Ted? Like, I make
right,
everybody's
I know you do
name
that.
Very
well. Pro tip, Mike, the same thing.
Yeah.
This is my lovely wife, Rebecca.
Right.
Right.
And then he'll go, hi, I'm John. I'm like,
oh, that's how you do
or
it.
Or the other one, if I'm alone, I go like, what's up, you sexy beast?
I know. What's up, Playboy?
Man, you look like you lost weight. Distractionary maneuvers.
Distractionary
maneuvers. What we're saying is we don't know your name.
Man, we're trying, though.
Well, and then I just use, you know, general names for people all the time, even if I do know you, and then people start getting offended. Like, hey, dude, what's up? Mike, come on. You've known me for how many years? Like, no, I do know your name, Greg. I just don't want to call you Greg right now. You're my buddy, your guy.
Sometimes you're just wrong.
Yeah.
I walked up to a dude, gave him a big hug, and I was like, you crazy SOB? What are you doing at this festival? And the guy's like, I do not know you.
Oh.
Oh.
And I was like, and I saw him 2 nights later, like, dude, you look a lot like my friend. He's like, I know, but I swear I don't know you.
I have no idea who you are, strange man. Police in California stopped a car carrying a pizza. Miles, you will never believe what it was topped with.
What was it topped with?
Tell you all about it at 5:50.
Thank you, sir. Headlines are coming up at 5:50. In the meantime, let's get a contestant on the line for Profile This at 206-803-ROCK.
Therapy is known to be extremely helpful. But have you ever tried eavesdropping on someone else's problems? Listen to the new podcast, Say More with Dr. Sheila, starring Amy Poehler as the world-renowned self-proclaimed couples therapist.
You know, it's funny, as I was making the appointment to come today.
I'm sorry, I made the appointment.
I booked
the appointment.
Listen to Say More with Dr. Sheila on the free Odyssey app or wherever you get your podcasts.
Experience what your customer experiences with user testing. Whether you're launching a new product, prototype, or marketing campaign, you'll get real-time video feedback straight from the source. The User Testing Human Insight Platform lets you understand it all from your customer's perspective. You can target your exact audience, ask questions, and get a window into their world. The result? You feel what your customer feels so you can build the best experience imaginable. For a free trial, visit usertesting.com/audio.
When things feel a bit chaotic, Instacart helps deliver milk and sausage. Add a little life to your cart. Get stuff from literally all your stores, from baby wipes to albacore. Add a little life to your cart. Instacart helps get your groceries. Your first three deliveries are free.
Download Instacart. Add life to cart. Terms apply.
Looking to give the gift of pleasure? Add a little high heat to keep the desire burning. Or maybe you just need a little self-care. Come to Lovers for the best lingerie and toys to keep things hot this holiday. Save 20% on your purchase with Lovers Afterglow Rewards. Just mention LOVE20 at one of our 18 Western Washington locations. Offer valid with free Lovers Afterglow Rewards membership until November 30th. Some exclusions apply.
Hey, it's Mike Hawk. Want more Men's Room content? Follow the Men's Room page of the Odyssey app and check out my live stream, A Moment with Mike Hawk and Nothing in Particular with Steve the Thrill Hill. Going live Thursdays and Fridays at 1, exclusively on the Men's Room page of the Odyssey app.
Have we made it to drinking time?
Somebody out there deserves to be recognized. And the Men's Room knows just who it is. So to you, we say, bottoms up, sailor. You're the toast of our shot of the day.
Drink time it is. As usual, we head to the drink desk and Steve Throw Hill to find out who we're toasting.
Yes, indeed. And today we toast 24-year-old Cameron Spina of somewhere in Virginia. Listen. Except now Pennsylvania, but by way of Florida. You see, Spina graduated with a master's degree in global sports business from Rutgers in 2022. Now, over the summer, Cameron applied for a job as a cheerleading coach at a college in Virginia. She would not say which college because she doesn't want there to be any bad blood. But as Cameron said, quote, my first interview was amazing. It went an hour and a half, and it felt like I knew this guy my whole life. Good stuff. At the end of her second interview, the head coach said he wanted to hire. Good news. So she terminated her lease in Florida, booked a storage unit in Virginia, rented a U-Haul, and drove the 13 hours to the Virginia College campus. And after settling into her hotel, she then began working and immediately started carrying out her new responsibilities and coaching about 50 athletes there. It was on her seventh day of work that Cameron found out she'd never actually been hired.
Oh.
Yeah, they ended up, they liked her. They liked someone else more. They went with someone else. Somehow, after the second interview, she thought she had the job. She legitimately thought she had the job. She worked there for 7 days. People got along with her. And finally, someone from HR was like, who are you? She explained, oh, I'm new. And they're like, no, no, no. You don't work here. They went with somebody else. But to her credit, she's like, you know what? I'm not even mad. I'm mad at myself. I really should have followed.
Well, I mean, I do believe that she knew it. Nobody would go to a job for 7 days if it wasn't theirs.
And the worst part is, man, apparently the people she was called really liked her. And it's like, hey, guys, I know
what
she's
doing. Someone told them that.
I didn't actually get the job. Surprise!
Huh.
So we pour this booze, and we drink this booze because we think it's yummy.
Yummy!
So over the tongue and down the throat to party in our tummies. Down the hola, bitchola!
The Men's Room presents Profile This.
Hey, Stephen Throhill, could you please tell everyone how Profile This is played?
Sure, Gan Miles. It's a simple game where we share with you a real-life news story, something that happened right here on planet Earth. And as you listen to the story, based on the stereotypes you believe to be true of people and the decisions that people make, we'll ask you what it is you think makes the story a story. The phone lines are down. Ted and Miles are playing against each other.
Sweet. All right.
You understand how this your game is played?
Sure.
Well, you kind of dumbasses.
Analyze this. Is that a choice today?
Oh, no, we got drugs. Bite me and hit me with your best shot.
Oh, no, give me hit me then. Burrito.
I thought about using that one. Let's see. Hit me with your best shot. A vandal has admitted to throwing bricks and other things at parked cars. Now, at least two cars were hit, and one had its window smashed. Danny Reed was arrested that evening and charged with two counts of criminal damage. He was also charged with breaching a criminal behavior order, which was issued back in April of 2021, after an investigation found that he'd entered the driveway, basically trespass. Anyway, the 45-year-old appeared before a judge, pleaded guilty to all charges, and he will be sentenced a little bit later this month, and it's subject to a conditional bail. Now, the question is, in addition to bricks, what else did old Danny boy throw at parked cars? Was it garden gnomes, plastic deer, a ceramic lion, or a bird feeder? That's right, we're talking lawn art. So garden gnome, plastic deer, ceramic lion, or bird feeder. What was he throwing at cars?
Plastic deer.
How many cars did he mess up?
He hit two, broke the window out of one.
So this was a one-time incident.
One-time incident for the... He's known to the police. This is a new behavior for him, essentially.
Ceramic what?
Ceramic lion.
Lion. Oh, like the time...
Yes, bro, you know.
Yeah, I know.
People know that you're fancy by having a fake-ass lion in front of your house. Garden gnome, plastic deer, ceramic lion, or bird fear.
I like garden gnome, Ted.
Damn. I like gnomes, too, and I like the idea of the gnome just flying down with his point down first.
You know what I'm saying?
You know what? Man, I really wish it had been one of those.
I was hoping a
jockeys.
Bird feeder, because that would do some
God.
Damage.
Yeah, I've been around those.
What are those called again?
Racist jockeys?
Yeah.
I don't know.
No, there was a name for them. Yeah, there was a name for them. I can't
lawn
remember
jockeys?
The name.
Lawn jockeys?
Lawn jockeys, yeah. That's what it was.
I'll go with ceramic lion.
Ceramic lion. Remember when everyone had that?
Oh, I do.
Yeah. There was a lot of them.
What was he attacking cars with? Garden gnomes, plastic deer, ceramic lion, or a bird feeder? We'll find out next.
That was a tease.
I'm Snoop Dogg, and I'm giving up smoke. I know what you're thinking. Snoop, smoke is kind of your whole thing. But I'm done with it. I'm done with the coughing and my clothes smelling all funky. I'm going smokeless. Solo Stove Fix 5. They took out the smoke. Now you can have a nice blaze without any clouds ruining your day. Go smokeless. Go to solostove.com. Tell them Big Snoop Dogg sent you.
99.9 KISW. We return to the Men's Room with Miles and Thrill.
Categories, hit me with your best shot on Profile. This vandal admits to throwing bricks and other things at cars. He pled guilty and might do a little time. He did that, maybe a little probation. But either way, Question is, what else was this guy or gal throwing at cars? Garden gnomes, plastic deer, ceramic lions, or a bird feeder?
And that is a question I pose to you two fine gentlemen. Ted, you went with the ceramic lion.
Ceramic lion.
Oh, I'm afraid it was not the ceramic lion. Miles, you went with the garden gnome.
Garden gnome.
Which Ted was hoping that it was. And you are correct.
It was the gnome.
All right.
Damn it. Was the gnome. Years ago, we...
people who collect those things don't want them stolen.
They don't. Years ago, as far as plastic gear goes...
anybody that has one doesn't want it stolen.
No. We visited, you know our friends, Dizzle and her husband, John.
Sure.
They now live in Colorado, but at this point, they're still living outside of Baltimore. And my wife and I went to visit them, but it was around Christmas time. And just to piss them off, they're in rural Pennsylvania, so we stopped at this little side store because they had these big-ass lawn ornament deer, reindeer, that lit up with Christmas lights. Mm-hmm. So we bought two of them, pulled up to their house, and before we rang the doorbell, we set them both up in the yard. They're battery-operated, so the lights are on. Then rang the doorbell, and I remember Dizzle opened the door. She looks at me, looks in her yard, and goes, "What the F?" I said, "They're yours now." They still have them. They don't put them out, but they still have them.
They still have them.
Oh, yeah, they still have them. They were not pleased.
Mouse.
Yes. Now for all TV news all the time, time for TV Time and Ted.
And now, because your pathetic life is confined to countless hours in front of a talking box, the Men's Room presents TV Time with Ted.
Jesus.
Oh, no.
Now I'm falling apart.
Come on, man.
Go out to the, run to the printer, Mike. Run. Okay. Your choices tonight will be Seth Myers.
Hold on.
Let me get...
All right, Seth Myers.
He comes on after Jimmy Fallon, correct?
That is correct.
He does. Yeah. The issue is Stephen Colbert is over at CBS, but he doesn't. There's nobody in that nighttime slot yet.
Oh, really? After Corden's in.
Right, because James Corden. Right, and then I don't know how they could have filled it. Right, and then the Jimmys. I don't know how they could have filled it because the writer's strike started.
That makes it difficult.
So I think that was the issue. Oh. Or Ted Smith!
Is it Ted or is it late night?
That's right, there, the title. These guys have teams of talents. The writer has something come up for monologues each and every night. It is up to you to determine, is this an actual late night joke and from whom? Or could it be a V. Ted Smith original?
All right. The shoe brand Crocs recently unveiled its limited edition classic cowboy boot, which will go up for sale later this month. The boost will cost you $120 and all of your friends.
Seth Myers.
Ted Smith.
That's Seth Myers.
The shoe brand Crocs recently unveiled its new limited edition classic cowboy boot, which will go up for sale later this month. The boots will cost you $120 and all of your friends.
Restaurants that serve bottomless mimosas are starting to tack on an additional charge for each customer that vomits in their bathroom as a result. What's next? Brown fees at all-you-can-eat restaurants?
Eats that sort.
Yeah, I'll say it to you.
It's not me. It's the writer.
Son of a bitch.
That does seem wild.
It was not an option.
You know what, Miles? It wasn't. I apologize. It seems wild to have that rule. Like, oh, you puke in our bathroom, we're going to charge you. It's like, well, I don't know.
I feel like that means it happens a lot at certain places. But that said, how do they know it's you? I feel like you'd have to go out and confess, like, hey, I just puked in your bathroom.
I've brunched enough. You could look around the room and tell.
It was that guy.
Yeah, yeah. actually, it's probably that girl. Starbucks celebrated the 20th anniversary of its pumpkin spice latte. You know the pumpkin spice latte. The fall festival drink that comes out every July. And in honor of the big anniversary, Starbucks is giving out a free pumpkin spice temporary tattoos. Meanwhile, over at Dunkin', they're giving out real tattoos. Stop crying, you friggin' loser.
I think it's Kimmel.
Yeah, Kimmel.
Or not Kimmel, Fallon.
No, I'm saying Kimmel.
Fallon.
Starbucks celebrating the 20th anniversary of the pumpkin spice latte. You know the pumpkin spice latte. It's Starbucks' festive fall drink that comes out every July. Yeah. But get this, in honor of the big anniversary, Starbucks actually gave out free pumpkin spice temporary tattoos. Meanwhile, over at Dunkin', they're giving out real tattoos. Stop crying, you friggin' loser.
Jeez, man, I thought I was done. A runner in the Chicago Marathon over the weekend stopped when she saw a stray kitten. But only she could brag to the kitten about running a marathon.
That's going to be you.
Hey, Ted Smith.
A hell of a cheer.
Seth Meyers.
No,
the Chicago Marathon over the weekend stopped when she saw a stray kitten, but only so she could brag to the kitten about running a marathon.
That is not it. That is spot on.
Yeah, it is.
And it is a hell of an accomplishment.
Nobody disagrees with it.
Yeah.
And I don't.
Shut up. I don't mind talking about it. Yeah, whatever. I'm not going to get to it. I think people know my thoughts. I will say, there's sometimes, it's funny, recently I've been somewhere with a very high-level athlete in that kind of realm. And same thing. Like, it was only because, like, her husband was like, she's just being nice.
Right.
Or, you know what I mean? He's like, she just doesn't like to talk about it. Like, she just smokes people.
My sister-in-law runs marathon. You met her, right?
Yeah.
So, she runs marathons all the time. It's just what she does. She's that person. She does not brag about it at all. But there are certain marathons she was excited to get into, New York and Boston, because it costs you money.
You gotta qualify.
Blah, blah, blah. So she qualified. We were one of the sponsors, because like anything, you reach out to family, you throw a few bucks. So she's telling us about the marathon. And I said, look, man, you know, it's not anything I have any interest in doing, but congratulations on running 26 miles. And she was quick to point out, 26.2. I said, Meredith, I'm not impressed by 0.2. I can do that. I'm congratulating you on the first 26.
Yes.
That's the part that's impressive. 0.2 means nothing to me, but congratulations on the 26 before that. Jesus.
Seinfeld, right? I love Seinfeld. Seinfeld has, you know, one of, they'd say most controversial. I'll say, a lot of people would say one of the most disappointing
series finales
of all time. But it also, like,
what are you going to do? I mean, there's no, you're not going to.
It brought back every, like, almost every character there was. You kind of find out that they, like, you're like, oh, yeah, they are just kind of SE people, all four of them.
Yeah.
So I liked it. But I get at the end of a stand-up gig in Boston over the weekend, Jerry Seinfeld did a Q&A. Someone asked him if he was happy with the way the show ended, and he dropped this bombshell. Quote, I have a little secret for you about the ending. Something is going to happen that has to do with the ending. Hasn't happened yet. And just what you're thinking about, Larry David and I have also been thinking about it. So you'll see. We'll see. I am not positive, but I think Larry David was gone by the last season.
I didn't know.
Oh, really?
Yeah, actually, because I just saw a clip the other day of Jason Alexander, and they asked him how the show changed after Larry left.
Oh, okay. He was saying it wasn't.
So, like, I could imagine if Jerry and Larry, that's kind of funny.
I know.
Created it, then they probably, like, if you want to redo that ending, it'd be like, well, we gotta get Larry back.
Those would be, yeah.
Well, also, Curb is done. Well, is according it? To them. I mean, not in a Rolling Stones way, but Larry,
right.
Larry said this would be the last year of that, so that would open up that opportunity. Because they've already it's in the can.
All right. You know what? I gotta get back into Curb. I fell off a few years ago, and then, yeah, I just haven't got back into watching it. But always a very good show. I think I've talked about this before, that I love watching Anthony Bourdain's No Reservations. And funny, last night I started, this is an episode I've probably watched 10 times, right? He goes to Kansas City and he's got his buddy, I can't think of his name, but it's the Russian guy that, like, it's just kind of goofy and hangs out with him or whatever. But the point I wanted to make is I'm watching the show and I always forget that, like, Steve, you've been there. Mike, you've been there. Mike, but you didn't tailgate.
No.
So they're in Kansas City. They're going around different food spots, but on the final two segments, Bourdain's like, oh, we're going to go do something I swear I'd never do, blah, blah, blah. Because Bourdain is just one of those people, right?
He's that guy, right?
He always hates everybody else's french fries. And he's just like, I don't want to tailgate. These are the exact people I don't like to hang out with.
Yeah.
Which I get from his point of view. Now, I will say from my point of view, right, when I moved out here, you know, hippies and smoking the weed and this and that, I would never think about going to a festival. Then I went to a couple festivals and I was like, oh man, this is pretty fun.
Not your festival guy.
Yeah, these people are pretty cool. And when you watch that episode, it's funny, like, Bourdain's talking about it and, like, you know, they're throwing the football around. This was years ago, probably like 2010, because Kansas City sucks. They're playing the Packers. But he's like, well, these people are really nice.
So you can see him turning the corner.
You can see him, right? And he's like, well, there's a lot of food. And he's like, some of this is good food. And then he's like, and there's a lot of booze. And then he's like, it has nothing to do with the game. And he, like, asked a group of them. He's like, so what is this about? What does this have to do with the game? Or is this just eating and drinking? And the guy's like, it's just eating and drinking. Mm-hmm. And it's funny. He, like, by the end of it, he's like, man, like, you could see it wash over him. It's like, yeah, I know that looks like bro, simple kind of culture.
It's really not that, man.
And he summed it up best for me. And I said this to someone years ago at Burning Man. I said, a lot of those people will say, I don't watch sports ball, this and that. And sure. I said, have you ever been tailgating? They were like, no, I don't watch sports ball to do that. I go, look, tailgating is a festival. For a day, you show up, you got your spot, right? You got to set everything up. You make food, you have drinks, you got drink. There's kids, there's adults, there's everybody. You're kind of, it's like a neighborly kind of environment.
And everyone kind of gets along. When we were in KC, I mean, it was cold as hell, and we're rocking our Raven stuff, but all these KC people, and very friendly crowd, I'll give them that. They were just like, hey, you guys are here for Baltimore. I'm like, well, I live in Seattle now, but Baltimore's my team. I bleed purple. That's how it goes. Hey, man, we got barbecue. Try our barbecue, right? So we're eating their food. You're talking to them. You talk about anything other than football for the most part. Like, I know who you like. You know who I like. And then there was 17 degrees that day, so it's cool. They all loaded us up with hand warmers. They're like, man, not just your hands. Put them in your shoes, which, by the way, that's very serious. Definitely put them in your shoes. Made a difference in that game. They were fantastic, and the food is so stupidly good. Everyone there does barbecue, right? So it doesn't matter which tailgate you went to, you're going to get barbecue. It's just, do you want ribs? Do you want brisket? Do you want sausage? We had a fantastic time. I cannot say enough
about how cool they were. I went to LSU in 06, 07. There's a guy. I still text him at least once or twice a year, and he's like, Smith boys, good to hear from you.
The great thing about tailgating is, too, you're not responsible for it. It's like going over to someone else's house for Thanksgiving.
For a party, right.
You didn't light the charcoal. You didn't get there early. You didn't pay a dime. All you did was bring a 12-pack of beer.
And eat.
Well, a lot of people set up their own tailgates.
No.
He's right. What I'm saying is, I don't. I just go to other people. So, like, for me, it's like going to Thanksgiving at someone else's house. I'm like, I have never set up a tailgate before in my life because you don't have access to the parking or whatever it takes to get in there.
It's fine. It's part of the routine. Now, I will say, speaking of sports, this is a little bit of a sad story, but Barry Melrose has been from ESPN. He's been diagnosed with Parkinson's. Mm-hmm. Basically, he retired. But I will say this, like, I didn't really think about it until last night. I was watching SportsCenter, and they're talking about it. It's like, right, like, Barry Melrose is kind of the face of hockey in the United States.
He absolutely is.
Yeah, and, like, you remember, like, he was a player in the league, didn't have the greatest stats in the world. He has, like, 10 points total in like 200 penalty minutes or 300.
So right? He's that guy.
Right, but he was a coach in the NHL. He was a coach for the Kings for years, and then he's been at ESPN forever. But man, like last night I was watching SportsCenter, and I forget who it was. I think it was Levy, and he's talking about him this and that, and he starts choking up, and I was like, God damn, I didn't realize how much I love Barry Melrose.
Well, you know, when you hear stuff like that, it really kind of hits you.
Yeah, and the other thing too is like, Barry Melrose is one of those people that does something awesome for a sport. Not that hockey wasn't popular in the 60s, 70s, and 80s in the USA, but it's like that guy's like the voice of it and the face of it, so you know it, and it gets you more interested in it. I mean, look, I didn't care about soccer. Then I met some friends that all played college soccer. So when people really can show you and show you what sports is about, especially that specific sport or whatever, it does a lot for it. So. Yep. Barry, like, I don't know how that diagnosis will go, but hopefully he can keep fighting there for a while and hopefully pull through. And, you know, either way, he's gone, and I don't blame him. Look, he said, look, I'm gonna be done. I'm gonna go spend time with my family.
Sure, absolutely.
And also, like, Barry Melrose always had the best suits, great hair. You know what I mean? Like, if his body's breaking apart, like, he doesn't want to be on TV.
Hockey coaches and experts have great hair.
Oh, hockey has the best flow in sports. I mean that's where that term comes from.
Look at the Kraken coach. Perfect part.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. Like, hockey has the best flow. Lacrosse players will say they do, but it's hockey.
I don't know.
If you're an Archer fan, watch the series finale tonight at 10 p.m.
Oh, serious?
Thank you, Sam. We appreciate it. You're listening to The Men's Room.
Dealing with an accident and injury claim can be overwhelming. Let Phillips Law Firm fight for you. We understand the pain and suffering, and we're here to guide you through. Call 1-800-JUSTICE today for a free case review or visit justiceforyou.com and let Phillips Law Firm help you on the road to recovery.
The Men's Room returns with Miles and Thrill. Now, let's see what's happening in the real world.
All right, here we go to Dearborn, Michigan, where three different men have been caught spanking it in public three times this week. Meanwhile, a low-flying helicopter in Australia is making crocodiles do the freak. Florida man gets his 30th felony after shooting down a drone in the sky, but it was a police drone.
Mm-hmm.
Stealing from Hardee's customers to bail out inmates is not going to fly. And a cemetery worker accidentally falls into an open grave. But you already knew that. It's time for your headlines.
Now, it's time to hit the head. Lines. Here's Mike Hawk.
All right, our top story. We're going to California, where a man had interesting toppings on his pizza. The man's car was stopped by authorities for a simple code violation. Unfortunately for him, he had a misdemeanor warrant that gave officers cause to search his car, where they found a sawed-off shotgun, a handgun, meth, Xanax, cocaine, fentanyl, and a delicious pizza. During the search, the officers pulled open the box to find not only a fantastic meat lover-style pizza with pepperoni, ham, sausage, and cheese, but a second handgun as well.
Jesus, man.
He now faces several charges, which I wouldn't recommend putting your guns inside of your pizza box. That's just that's just messy.
I don't know that he really cared about eating this pizza.
That's fair. Which is just a crime. Don't screw up a doggone pizza to do your illicit activities, man.
How'd you know it was a meat lover? Is that in the story?
Well, no. I could look at the thing.
Oh. Yeah, they opened it. They showed a picture of it, and you're like, that's a meat lover.
Right. All right. I was gonna give credit to whatever news organization was just like, by the way, what's the Supreme?
They did say that it had pepperoni, sausage, and cheese on it. I was like, that's a doggone meat lover. I see the ham. You left out the ham on there. I can totally see it.
Yeah, you're right. Without that third meat, I'm just having pepperoni and sausage.
Right.
That third meat shows up. It's a meat lover's.
If you got two meats, you're just involved. If you got three, that's your meat lover's.
It's the truth.
Mm-hmm.
Right?
Mm-hmm.
Right? I mean, like, think about when you go get a burger at a restaurant. Bacon cheeseburger. Sure. Mm-hmm. You throw on like a slice of ham or something, it's the ultimate burger.
That's right.
Right.
That is exactly right. And the other thing about that is that the meat lovers cannot have a single vegetable on it. If you do throw any vegetable whatsoever, it is either, it is at very least a subpar Supreme pizza.
Correct.
Agreed.
Right? Now, I like onions. I like peppers. I like olives. I like a Supreme pizza. Let's just be honest with it. But if I'm getting meat lovers, there's no greenery at all on that thing.
No. Unless your meat's green, in which case I'm not eating it.
Correct.
Oh. But I do say no more than three toppings on a pizza.
I'll disagree with you on that one, Mike.
I know. That's just my own personal.
It does get heavy. I'll give you that. It gets cumbersome to eat the pizza. But
I just like more than one slice.
Yeah.
And I feel like I'm getting into Chicago style once I go farther.
You can eat two Chicago.
It's like the old North Lake pizza, man. Critically acclaimed. People loved it. You could only eat one piece of that pizza because it was so topped with crap.
Gotcha. Thanksgiving dinner on a dough.
Pretty much.
In other news, two officers with the LAPD lost their jobs after things got a little too comfortable on the job.
How comfortable?
Back in 2017, the pair were accused of ignoring a call to back up an officer on a robbery call and were fired the next year after an investigation confirmed it. They did their best to appeal the decision to save their careers, one having lasted 17 years and the other just 7, but the decision was ultimately upheld by the Court of Appeal. Now the footage has been released, which leaves no question that the pair ignored the call to play Pokemon Go.
Jesus.
Oh, wow.
God, guys.
All right.
Look, I enjoyed that game when I was playing it.
I know, but would you, like, ignore phone calls?
No. Well, you know, personal ones? Sure.
I guess
not if I'm in my squad car.
Like, it's a call from work. Mike, right. Emergency. Sorry, Cass. I'll get you as soon as I find Shizuku. I don't even know if that's one.
Shizuku.
My kids. I was like, dude, good pull.
They for a hot minute, they were into not Pokemon Go, but Pokemon cards.
Sure.
And all the names were something like that.
Oh, yeah. Men's Room Sports. The MLB playoffs continue. Earlier today, Atlanta went for Game 3 against Philadelphia, with Philadelphia going up 2-1 in the series against Atlanta. Game 4 will be upcoming. Meanwhile,
Bryce Harper put on a display.
Yes, he did. Unfortunately for our Baltimore Orioles, they did go down to the dreaded Texas Rangers, who will then advance to the old ALCS. The Houston Astros are in Minnesota taking on the Twins for Game 4. That's over on FS1 about halfway through that game. It's nearing its finish.
All right.
And then later on tonight, the LA Dodgers are in Arizona taking on the Diamondbacks for Game 3. That'll be over on TBS.
That's wild. The Diamondbacks are kind of giving it to them.
I know, right? But that is it for your headlines. With that, Mike Hawk is out.
Thank you, sir. We appreciate it. We'll see you next time for a turn of Big Dummy. And the head chef is back with Ted's Meat and Potatoes. The lovely Taryn Daly is up next.
Yes, indeed. It's all true. But in the meantime, well, we be all about this bitch for 180 seconds or so. So until then, please do what you do best. And for Aletha's sake, stay beautiful.
The Men's Room has been taped before a live studio audience. Wardrobe and makeup provided by Mantastic Limited. This has been a presentation of the Men's Room Radio Network.
Flush production.
Getting older means a world of change, but some things still stay the same, like being at risk for type 1 diabetes, because type 1 can happen at any age. So screen it like you mean it. If just one person in your family has type 1, you're up to 15 times more likely to get it too. And 50% of type 1 diagnoses happen after the age of 18. So screen it like you mean it. Type 1 diabetes starts long before you need insulin, and one blood test could help you spot it early and lower the risk of serious complications like diabetic ketoacidosis, known as DKA. So don't get caught by surprise. Screen it like you mean it, because getting answers now can help you get prepared. The more you know, the more you can do. So don't wait. Talk to a doctor about how to get screened. Tap now or visit screenfortype1.com to learn more. Again, that's screenfortype1.com. And screen it like you mean it.
Therapy is known to be extremely helpful. But have you ever tried eavesdropping on someone else's problems? Listen to the new podcast, Say More with Dr. Sheila, starring Amy Poehler as the world-renowned self-proclaimed couples therapist.
You know, it's funny, as I was making the appointment to come today.
I'm sorry, I made the appointment.
I booked
the appointment.
Listen to Say More with Dr. Sheila on the free Odyssey app or wherever you get your podcasts.
Transit is better with an Orca card. Here's why. One, it's easy. Just tap and pay your way onto Metro and all other public transit around the Sound. Two, your tap shows us when and where you're riding the most, so Metro can serve you better. And three, Orca cards are for everyone. 18 and younger now ride free with a free youth Orca card. So what are you waiting for? Get an Orca card, tap for transit, and make your ride count today. Visit kingcounty.gov/tap for transit.